Thanksgiving Day Parade Thursday morning. Sasha Nixon, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:04.
Emmer and Nigel here for Window Nation. Get ready to have a blast of winter. Yeah, that next brutal blast of wicked, wild, and windy weather is on its way, and the only thing going down is the temperature. Heating costs will soar as much as 28% from last year, but you could cut your energy bills by up to 30%, increase your home's value, and get amazing savings. Call Window Nation today. Buy two windows, get two free, with no interest payments until 2025.
Your new windows will lock out the cold, blocking even the smallest draft, and keep your energy bills lower despite their ever-rising costs. With 0% interest until 2025, you'll have plenty of extra cash for your holiday spending. Make your home truly warm, comfortable, and inviting. Call Window Nation today, 866-90-NATION, or go to windownation.com. Get two windows free with every two that you buy, 0% interest until 2025, 866-90-NATION, or go to windownation.com. Discover why over 250,000 homeowners say Window Nation is the perfect fit.
With traffic on the fives at 3:05, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, looking at the east side, southbound 465, stop and go traffic before 70 down to south Shadeland Avenue. Inbound 65 slows at west and on the south side, eastbound 465 tight from Mann Road over to Emerson Avenue. Traffic sponsored by Freegee and Freegee Auctioneers. Freegee and Freegee Auctioneers is hosting a public auction on December 3rd in Clayton, Indiana. Info at freegeeauctioneers.com, that's F-R-E-I-J-E, auctioneers.com. License AC312-0002. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And a forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Partly cloudy skies through the night tonight. We'll see lows fall to 34. Skies become mostly cloudy on Thanksgiving. It still remains warm with highs near 57. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
And I'm Harrison Silcox. On the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters?
They're weirdos. On 93 WIBC.
So let's rock it!
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. My name is Nigel. Jason Hammer is here. I love these stories about Indianapolis and some of the good things, some of these big events coming to our town. It's just been announced that the NCAA will be the host of the 2029. Indy will be the host of the Men's Final Four Championship in 2029. What? Is this like nine times now?
I think that might be the 10th time, actually.
Wow. So another Men's Final Four coming in a few years.
So we have it in 2026. And then again in 2029. Now, yes, the NCAA headquarters are here in Indianapolis, so we're always going to get, you know, a good look by the selection committee. But let's be honest, even if the NCAA headquarters were not here, nobody does the Final Four and big events better than Indianapolis. That's why we're so adamant about let's keep this city on the rise. Let's get a good firm grip on what's happening with the homeless and the crime. So more of these events keep coming back to Indianapolis.
When are we going to do another Super Bowl? That's a big one.
I don't think Indy's going to get another one. I'm just going to be honest with you.
You're going to throw that out there? You're going to make that claim right here on live radio? No more Super Bowls for Indy? We got lucky that year.
We did. We caught lightning in a bottle with that weather, didn't we? It was beautiful. I remember going down to the Super Bowl Village one day without a jacket. Can you imagine going downtown Indianapolis first week of February without a coat or a jacket? It was amazing. But anytime you build a new stadium in the NFL, usually they'll throw you a bone and give you a Super Bowl to host. We built a new stadium. We got a Super Bowl and we rocked it out. I'm also afraid that if we host another one, that the weather's going to suck, and there's no possible way we could do better than that first time. Because I believe Indy was the first one to have that zip line go up and down the village.
Georgia Street?
Right.
That was so much fun. Man, those were the good old days. We had our podcast there, down right in the heart of it, that Thursday night before the Super Bowl.
Yes.
Packed. But it's too bad that people don't understand that this is a place where we can do that multiple times. And depending on where you're staying, you don't have to go outside to get to Lucas Oil.
Right. The connection of downtown, right. The way that it's designed, is another reason why so many of these events come back every year, whether it's the NFL Combine or the Final Four, these big conventions like the Firefighters Convention. They love that you don't necessarily have to jump into a cab or an Uber to get from one part of Indy to another.
How many times, okay, do you have the lineage, the timeline of Final Fours?
Okay, so the first time was in 1980. And
who won? Didn't IU win in 80?
No, they were 81.
81, okay.
Right, IU won in 81, and that was the night Reagan got shot. In 1980, wow. I believe, wow. Somebody will correct me, I think Purdue might have made the Final Four, but they got beat. I think Louisville was the winner that year. And then in 1991, that was Duke. Yeah, they upset that stout UNLV squad. And then 97, 2000, 2006, 2010, 2015, 2021.
Now, that's right. Forget about last year. It was the whole thing last year. Right. It was the entire tournament.
Right.
The bracket was here last year kind of because of the COVID setup.
And the NBA All-Star Game is coming to Indy not this year, but the following year, 2024. And then you've got 2026 for the men, 2029 for the men, and 2028, the women's Final Four, will be at Gainbridge Fieldhouse.
Oh, cool.
So, again, cool. It just shows you what kind of city we have, but these events will stop coming unless we start fixing some problems around here.
Just a quick side note question. You might not even know. I'm sure you do, though. How's your cousin's team doing?
Oh, Katie Gerald,
yeah.
Head coach of the Lady Boilers.
Right. When I said your cousin's team, I meant Coach Gerald's for the women's Purdue team. How are they doing? Because I know the IU women's is ranked.
Yep. IU women are up there at number 6. Katie's going to have a better squad than a year ago. This is year 2. She's only been able to recruit her players one season because she kind of came in last minute last year.
That's right.
And it wasn't her group. But I talked to her a little bit on text, and she's excited. She thinks they're going to be better. They can make a run. So I'm excited for her, and I hope they have a great season. But I'm also looking forward to all of the transportation of the homeless downtown, Nige. Because anytime this city hosts a Final Four or a big event like that, it's almost magic how the homeless all disappear and they go to that airport hotel over there, the Crown Plaza Hotel by the old airport.
Those are cozy digs.
That's right, a great gig. I wonder if they get free transportation over there. Because, you know, if you're a homeless dude.
Well, they ain't walking.
If you're a homeless dude, what's the motivation for you to, you know, go out and get a gig? You're going to just come downtown, raise your hand and say, can I get a free hotel room for about a week or so? Because I know you want the city to look good, but we're not going anywhere. So once you put us up in that hotel over there that Ryan Mears talked about in that prosecutor's debate, and we'll be back here in a couple weeks. So good luck with that. There's an Indiana lottery ticket worth $2 million that's about to expire in a couple weeks.
Oh, no.
Somebody has a winning Hoosier Lottery Powerball ticket. They purchased this in June at a gas station in Rushville, and it's set to expire December 15th. It's worth $2 million.
Oh,
they bought it at a McClure Oil station, and it's from the June 18th drawing of the Hoosier Lottery. Can you imagine not cashing in a $2 million ticket?
Here's what I couldn't imagine. Having it expire and then finding the ticket the next day.
Oh, no.
Well, honey, I won the lottery. $2 million. Wait a minute. It's December 16th. It expires yesterday.
Oh, man.
It might be, you know, jumping off a roof time. It might be chaos if that happened. You're telling me the lottery wouldn't make good on an expired ticket?
No, not at all. Folks that pass out money for a living, Nige, they're not apt to do it when they don't have to. Like, Las Vegas has changed. I talk about this a lot because I go to Vegas a lot. The perception of Vegas, for those who haven't been there in a long time, is that as long as you're gambling, you're getting free drinks and cocktails and 99-cent buffets and shrimp. Those days are long gone.
Dude, I would sit there and play Keno in the late 90s, early 2000s with my buddies, and the Pacers playoff games would be on. And because I was playing Keno at like a dollar a pop,
right,
I'd be getting free Miller Lights the entire time. You're telling me it's not like that anymore?
No. They give you a ticket. Like if, let's say you're betting sports at the sports book.
Yeah.
I had $500 in bets lined up and I turned them into the ticket. This is before you could use your apps and things like this.
Yep.
And I go up to the window. It's at the Mirage. $500 worth of sports bets. They gave me 3 drink tickets.
That's
I could
ridiculous.
Get 3 Miller Lights for $500 that I just bet on sports. And if you complain about it, if you say, dude, what happened here? They just give you, well, it's the policy now. It's the policy now. That sucks. Now, if you can talk your way into more, be my guest. But yeah, things have changed out there, man. And the lottery, I'm telling you, if you go in there a day late.
Sorry about you.
The moose out front should have told you. AAA says that this is going to be the third busiest Thanksgiving holiday in terms of travel of all time, which also means that you're going to see a lot of state police out on the roads.
Oh, man. I saw 3 stateies on my way here just on 65 alone from Boone County today, for sure.
Trying to reduce the recklessness and the drunk driving, because tonight it's a big party night. A lot of folks are going to go out and drink. It's tradition the night before Thanksgiving.
I used to love the night before Thanksgiving. I used to love it. I was all about it.
And now?
I'm going to go home and have a few drinks, watch some Christmas movies with the kids tonight.
Life comes at you fast, man.
I'm not going out at all. No, of course I'm not going out tonight.
But if you are going out, again, be careful. There's a bunch of people that are going to overdo it tonight. We call this one of the amateur hours of the calendar year. Tonight, New Year's Eve, St. Patrick's Day, a bunch of people who don't normally drink, boozing it up with their buddies and family, and then getting out there on the roads. Maybe they've had too much to drink. They're probably looking at their phone. So be careful. And also, there's a lot of state police out there trying to pull you over tonight. You mentioned you're going to watch some Christmas movies with the family tonight, right?
Oh, sure. Hallmark Channel's big in our house.
Oh, dude. The Hallmark Channel's countdown to Christmas. It's been in full swing for a while.
Sure.
But why not serve up a little Thanksgiving holiday romance tonight?
Tonight on the Hallmark Channel, it's Thanksgiving in a subway station. He's a homeless young musician who plays an empty paint bucket for loose change on a disgusting New York City subway platform. She's a gorgeous talent agent from Nashville in search of a gifted drummer, but was bitten by a rat when she was a girl visiting the big city. Will he trade his drumsticks for turkey drumsticks at her place? Or will he keep beating the bucket? Starring Jennifer Love Hewitt's roommate in one of her old shows, and the square-jawed actor who played cute guy in The Stairwell one time on Big Bang Theory.
Oh, excuse me.
Thanksgiving in a subway station. Tonight on the Hallmark Channel.
Yeah,
that totally sounds like a Hallmark movie.
I've got a DVR, actually. I'll be watching that later.
One option you have is the Pacers game tonight. I believe the Pacers are in action downtown taking on Minnesota. 2 pretty good teams. I dig this Pacers team, man. So if you're going out tonight looking for something to do, I know tickets are cheap. Go check out the Pacers. All right, Matt Bear, we got folks that are hitting the road. So here's what I want to do. All right, so Kylan, go ahead and kill this traffic music for a second. Do we have the holiday road music? Can you cue up something a little bit more appropriate for this travel day? Go ahead and turn that up, Miss Kylan. And Matt Bear, let's get people on that holiday road. Let's go.
Do the best we can. Don't start on Michigan Road. That's a bad place to start. Southbound Michigan Road is 77. We have a crash, possible entrapment. On the east side, southbound 465. Stop and go before 70 down to 74, then slow to Arlington Avenue. South side, eastbound 465, slows from Mann Road over to Emerson Avenue. Traffic sponsored by Mattress Firm. Don't miss the Black Friday sale. Shop Tempur-Pedic to save up to $500 on select adjustable mattress sets and get a $300 instant gift good towards sleep accessories. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates. The Moose said we're open. I'm Matt Bear, WIBC Traffic.
61 right now. I'll take this. 61 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. Hammer and Nigel Show, Thanksgiving extravaganza. More when we come back.
Tony Katz.
When you start going down this idea that the people you disagree with aren't human, the rhetoric... The dehumanization leads to disaster. It leads to violence. It leads to bloodshed. The people who want to scream anybody they disagree with is a Nazi, that's the dehumanizing, that's a real issue. I think everyone needs a bourbon and needs to calm down.
Tony Katz, mornings 6 to 9 on 93 WIPC and WIPC.com.
Right now, buy 4 Ultimate Washes and get 2 free, available online or at any crew car wash location. Plus, get a free bonus wash now through November 30th.
A story of first downs and second chances. Meet former pro football player Michael Robinson.
I wanted to keep playing, but my feet hurt.
And all those big league experts couldn't help?
You have access to anything, but none of it worked.
Finally, he got fitted with Goodfeet arch supports.
Let me tell you something. They work.
Now, he recommends Goodfeet to
anybody. If you move, go to the Goodfeet store.
Sign up for your free fitting at goodfeet.com. The children's music and dance teacher who couldn't cha-cha.
I was always on my feet. It was just so painful.
Elisa couldn't let her students down. So she stepped up and went to the Goodfeet store for personally fitted arch supports.
I would work an entire day and my feet didn't hurt at the end of the day. That was when I knew, wow, these are different.
But the really good part?
It's good to be dancing together again.
Stop by or schedule your free fitting at goodfeet.com.
Come in for a free fitting, no appointment needed. The Goodfeet Store, in the north, near Keystone at the Crossing or in Greenwood.
It's Terry Stacy, and I'm ready for a huge shopping weekend. Supporting local at family-owned Cynthia's Hallmark with 4 locations and with Black Friday specials all weekend long. 25% off everything you can fit inside a bag and one item you cannot. Exclusions apply. 50% off Vera Bradley totes in perennials gray, plus a free coin purse to match. 30% off Pandora at Cynthia's in Greenfield. Exclusions apply. Cynthia's carries all of your favorites. Hallmark, Yeti, Mud Pie, Nora Fleming, Dimdaco, Life is Good, and exclusive Squishmallows. Shop Small Business Saturday and get a popular buffalo plaid tunic for just $12.98. Shop Cynthia's Hallmark store on Giving Tuesday and receive a Shine Like the Stars tote bag with any purchase. Donate to the Alzheimer's Association in memory of Cynthia, and Cynthia's Hallmark will match donations up to $5,000. Happy holidays from Cynthia's Hallmark, 116th and Allisonville Road, 116th and Brook School Road, 96th and Lantern Road, and off I-70 in Greenfield.
Buy 4 tires and get up to $260 in savings after rebate at Bell Tire's Black Friday sale. Or get even more in Bell Tire gift cards with extended hours Friday, Saturday, and Monday only. Plus, get tires as low as $49 after rebate. Buy 4 tires and get up to $260 in savings at our absolute biggest sale of the year. Don't miss out. Sale ends Monday, November 28th. Get up to $260 in savings. Or get even more. Buy online, save time. Choose the lowest tire price, period, at Bell Tire. See store or belltire.com for details. Restrictions apply.
Do you have a wet basement problem? Hi, I'm Mike Smith with Swenco Crawl Space and Basement Repair, Indy's most trusted basement waterproofer. Your basement is a very important part of your home. Whether it's finished or unfinished, there's nothing worse than a wet, unusable basement. Swenco's basement waterproofing will fix your wet, unusable basement permanently and forever. Protect your greatest asset, your home, by waterproofing your basement today. Call the real, local, family-owned waterproofing experts at Swenco Crawl Space and Basement Repair, 317-407-1868 or swencollc.com.
Hello, this is Don Steffi, Executive Director for the Indianapolis Ballet. Tis the season, is it not? Or is it Nut? The Nutcracker, a family tradition brought to life by your Indianapolis Ballet. December 16th through the 18th at the Murrah Theater Old National Center. Don't miss this delightful classic for the whole family to enjoy. Brilliant and festive dancing, colorful sets and costumes, Tchaikovsky's beautiful music, and a whole lot more. Indianapolis Ballet's The Nutcracker. Tickets on sale now at indieballet.org.
At Uline, they know going the extra mile takes hard work. For companies pushing to go further, Uline will go the distance with you. 24/7, they answer the phone to get you the shipping and industrial supplies you need. Business can move fast. Unexpected large orders, adverse weather, new safety guidelines, and changing economic trends. Uline works hard keeping 38,000 items ready to ship, minimizing detours on your way to the extra mile. Visit uline.com.
Tune in this weekend for Everyday Wealth with Soledad O'Brien and Gene Chatsky, presented by Edelman Financial Engines. For airtimes, visit everydaywealth.com.
Get Meijer Black Friday deals all week long, like buy one, get one for a dollar on shoes for the family. In-store only. Get more for your money at Meijer.
This hour on 93 WIBC is powered by Pierce Jewelers, Carmel's diamond fashion store.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show on 93 WIBC.
Be sure and follow us on YouTube. You can listen at home on the smart speaker. Follow us on all the social media platforms. From what I understand, the YouTube's been going in and out on us today, so you might be able to see us at some times or only hear us at other times during the show. It's been in and out. Somebody's working on that. It's not me. I have no idea who. There's nobody in the building right now.
Right. We put the ticket in. It's like, hey, you know, the YouTube keeps cutting in and out, and I have a feeling it's going to be ignored in the order that it was received. So if it goes down, we haven't been fired. If your device you're listening to starts screwing up, we've not been fired.
From what I understand, you'll be able to hear us but not see us if that's the case.
And at 5:30 today, we have IU basketball.
Yeah.
So let me just say this before we start getting bombarded with messages. We're not allowed to stream sporting events, right? Whether it's IU basketball, the Indy 500, if we ever air a Pacer or Colts game, whatever, because of the rules of, you know, the sporting leagues. So your app is probably okay. Everything's going to be working fine. You just won't hear anything after 5:30 while the game is going on. It'll come back after the game. So it is the day before Thanksgiving. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show. Thank you so much for joining us. And it feels like it wouldn't be the season of giving if we didn't give you this. It's the annual playing of one of the great Thanksgiving traditions in broadcasting, the episode of WKRP where they drop the turkeys from the sky.
Something just came out of the back of the helicopter. It's a dark object. Perhaps a skydiver plummeting to the earth from only 2,000 feet into the air. Oh, my God, they're turkeys! Oh, they're crashing to the earth right in front of my eyes! One just went through the windshield of a parked car!
Running around pushing each other, the turkeys are hitting the ground like sacks of wet cement.
As God is my witness, I thought turkeys could fly.
That was when they were doing the turkey drop promotion at WKRP.
Right. And Les Nessman was the reporter on scene.
My kid's friend, he had a sleepover the other night, and his friend and his dad have a couple turkeys outside their house, and they originally bought a couple so they could eat it for Thanksgiving, but the kids like kind of they turned into pets, so they're just out there now. And he said, I was talking with the dad when I was picking Connor up a couple of weeks ago, and he said, yeah, because they're on, you know, like a country road, and sometimes people will pull over, roll down their window. He said this lady pulled over and rolled down her window and just went rolled her window up and kept moving. And I looked at her and I said, man, Mayor Emily's not doing too well. That's bizarre behavior for the mayor of Zionsville.
It's not very mayor-like. That's what you're telling me.
But the turkey story is true. Some people keep them as pets. That's awesome.
Have you ever seen a turkey in the wild? Like when we go to Tennessee down to like Pigeon Forge and Gatlinburg and we'll stay in a cabin, every once in a while up there in the sticks in the Smoky Mountains, you'll see wild turkeys running
around.
Wild
turkeys in every state. Yeah. I haven't seen one personally. I haven't like almost hit one on the side of the road or anything. But, and I definitely haven't bought my own live turkey only to, you know, defeather it and skin it and eat it myself.
Yeah, it sounds like a lot of work.
Yeah.
Sounds like a lot of work.
We have people that do that for us.
So Mr. High and Mighty here, afraid to murder his own Thanksgiving feast.
I swear to God, my kids don't know. I don't think they know what turkey is, or even sometimes hamburger or steak. They like all that stuff, but they don't fully understand or grasp yet where all that stuff really comes from and how it's processed.
There's that old expression, you know, you don't want to know how the sausage is made.
Sure.
And I don't think they're at that age just yet. All right, coming up next, I think I saw Rob Kendall. He's one of the few people still in this building.
Rob's still here.
Let's get Rob in here for kind of a bonus off the rails since we're off tomorrow. That's coming up next on the Hammer and Nigel Show.
If you run a small business, you need the most from every investment. That's why Comcast Business gives you more. Like more innovation with our new gig speed Wi-Fi, plus unlimited data. More speed from the largest, fastest, reliable network for small businesses. And more savings, up to 60% a year with Comcast Business Mobile. All from the company that powers more businesses than any other provider. When you need more, you need Comcast Business. empowering possibilities.
Get started with internet and advanced security for just $40 per month for 12 months with no annual contract when you add mobile. Plus, ask how to get a $750 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Ends 1/1/2023. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary. Compare pricing of top carriers. Requires EcoBill and AutoPay. Comcast Business Internet required. New Comcast Business 100 megabits per second internet and Security Edge customers only. Equipment taxes and other fees extra and subject to change. Must add mobile within 90 days of internet install and keep services for 12 months for discount. Results vary. Not an endorsement.
Trust 1 Hour Heating and Air Conditioning to help keep your heater running strong. Call 855-1-HOUR or visit 1hourair.com.
Always on time, or you don't pay a dime.
Independently owned and operated, licensed in their respective state or county.
Huber has it.
Huber has all the top brands. Chevy, Buick, GMC, Ford, Acura, Honda, Mazda, Nissan, and more. And every new vehicle includes a 10-year, 200,000-mile warranty. Looking to sell your vehicle? We'll pay you top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Take it from Brooke Huber.
You can get a car anywhere, but you can only get a warranty like this at Huber. 10 years, 200,000 miles.
Visit drivehubler.com.
Huber has it all.
Warranty available on new vehicles except certain models not transferable or available on leases. A copy of the warranty is available for review at the dealership.
Hey, Dak Prescott here. Why do I choose proven quality sleep from Sleep Number? Because better sleep elevates my game. My Sleep Number 360 smart bed helps me fall asleep faster, keeps me cool, and effortlessly adjusts for my best sleep. That's more focus, more edge, and more highlights. And that means more wins for all of us.
Save 50% on the Sleep Number 360 limited edition smart bed plus special financing, only for a limited time. Sleep Number, the official sleep and wellness partner of the NFL. Special financing subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.
Complete an application for a refinance or purchase by the end of the year and receive up to $1,000 back at closing. TheHomeLoanExpert.com/Friday.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Who it was. 60 degrees and sunny in downtown Indy. All clear on the radar. Temperatures drop to the lower 30s tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 3:31. More information has been released about the man police say is responsible for a mass shooting at a Virginia Walmart break room last night.
This Walmart employee at the Walmart walked into that break room and opened gunfire before turning the gun on himself. We're told the gun was a pistol. Now there's more questions and answers right now from authorities, but we did get an update this morning from the police chief. We can tell you the suspect's name. Walmart has just confirmed to us here at Fox News that the alleged shooter has been identified as an individual named Andre Bing. Walmart confirms that he was an associate with the company and his position with the company was overnight team lead.
Fox's Griff Jenkins. Walmart says Bing had been with the company since 2010. The Justice Department wants to question former Vice President and Indiana Governor Mike Pence as part of its criminal investigation into former President Trump's efforts to overturn the 2020 election results. Several reports say investigators reached out to Pence a few weeks before Attorney General Merrick Garland appointed a special counsel to oversee the investigation as Trump makes another run at the White House. What do chocolates, caffeinated beverages, and tomato sauce all have in common? They're all things that could give you heartburn or acid reflux, but it can happen at any time, especially if you overeat this holiday.
Also, there's lots of symptoms that people might not think are related to reflux, like chronic cough or hoarseness and things like that. So we do see an increased number of that at this time of the year with the holidays.
Dr. Amanda Swingley at Ascension St. Vincent in Indianapolis says people often drink too much alcohol during this time of year. That can also cause heartburn or acid reflux. Holiday shoppers are out searching for deals, but you can still run into plenty of scams, says Attorney General Todd Rokita. Parker Carlson has more.
With 35% of all scams taking place online, your priority needs to be shopping at legitimate websites. You could check out the Better Business Bureau for known scam sites. Be extra alert when making emotional purchases like wedding dresses or pets, and never pay with gift cards or cash apps like Venmo. And above all else, remember, if a deal seems too good to be true, it probably is. Parker Carlson, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:33.
This holiday, give the people you treasure something they'll treasure. A gift from Shane Company. Our unique jewelry makes a spectacular gift. I'm Tom Shane. One of my favorites is an elegant necklace featuring a colorful east-west gemstone with diamond accents for $250. We offer it in four different gemstones, so you can select a color she loves. Choose red garnet, purple amethyst, sky blue topaz, or yellow citrine. Another favorite are Diamond Huggy earrings for $1,145. I picked these hoops because they fit close to the ear and are great for any occasion. Select either white gold, yellow gold, or rose gold. Our link necklace at $525 is a favorite because the diamond accents give the gold a touch of sparkle. Visit us for more gifts at a great value. Now you have a friend in the jewelry business. Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
The traffic at 334. What's going on, Matt Bear?
Harrison, looking at a crash. It's Michigan Road at 77th Street. And the southbound lanes are really backed up. But everything into 79th at the moment is really stop and go on Michigan Road. East side southbound 465 jams before 70 down to 74. South side westbound 465 slowing up through construction after 65 over to Harding. Same with the eastbound lanes from Man Road past a 31. Inbound 65 jams 21st Street. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware. Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep-in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden in Allisonville, Home and Garden by Sullivan. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Partly cloudy skies through the night tonight. We'll see lows fall to 34. The skies become mostly cloudy on Thanksgiving. It still remains warm with highs near 57. I'm Wish TV, Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
And I'm Harrison Silcox on the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
Hey, look who stumbled in the studio. Oh, wow. It's Rob Kendall from the Kendall and Casey Show making a rare Wednesday appearance, Wednesday before Thanksgiving. Hi, I'm Nigel. Jason Hammer's here. Rob's here. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show. Rob, I heard you guys talking earlier this morning about what your dad would say if you asked him to take a COVID test before Thanksgiving. First of all, we're losing a national icon. Dr. Anthony Fauci, the face of COVID, Trump's head of COVID response. His last press briefing was yesterday. It was kind of a debacle. I don't know. Yeah, you played some of that audio.
Yes.
Right? Somebody tried to ask him about the origins of COVID.
A legitimate question. Yeah. It's not like they asked him what color his underpants were.
And the White House press secretary had to step in and save the day and shield precious Lord Fauci from answering those questions. What did you think when you saw that?
Well, here's what's interesting is government is the only place where we accept, not only accept, but celebrate complete and utter failure. Like, if somebody screws up your order at the Taco Bell drive-thru, you are on the townie chatterboard within 5 minutes, and you are writing a letter with things, with words that we could never say on this radio
station.
Why is
everybody looking at me? Like, everybody in the studio just looked at me.
And yet, when it's government... And schools are always the best example of this. So when there's utter failure to follow through or whatever, and they never get held accountable, but they keep getting praised. And so with Fauci, there were two major issues that defined his 40 years in government. By the way, think about this. I was negative two when he started.
Highest paid federal government employee, right? And you were you weren't even born yet negative, when he started his career.
I'm a grown-ass middle-aged man, and I was negative two when Fauci started. And the two issues were AIDS and HIV and COVID. And in both cases, he made egregious mistakes and recommendations based on things that did not come to fruition. And it was the same mistake twice in the sense of with AIDS and HIV, from the beginning, they should have been pushing education and therapeutics on how to deal and live with this virus.
And what population was affected most by that disease.
Right, absolutely. And
look at, say it.
Look at now why we have a handle on AIDS and HIV. Why do we have it? Why are people living long, full lives with it? Because they focused on how to treat it once you have it and how to prevent people from getting it.
And you know what it was? It was people in that community that it was affecting the most that finally spoke out. It wasn't the government that was speaking out and who, you know, HIV and AIDS was affecting. It was the people that it was affecting that finally stepped forward and said, no, this is actually what's going on here.
if you watch that movie, Dallas Buyers Club, loosely based, but the bad guy in that movie is based off of Anthony Fauci.
Yeah, and so the 40 years later, same thing happens with COVID, where we knew, remember we used to do the, I remember when the two women, what were their name that used to work with, the two women?
Mock and Daisy.
Mock and Daisy, yes, chicks on the right. And every day, at whatever it was, when hi, Mock! Whatever, the dashboard would drop each day with the updated COVID stats, and we would read those stats.
Oh, yeah.
And like 3 weeks in, you knew, look, if you are elderly or you are a person with certain comorbidities, probably a huge deal for you or a much bigger deal for you. Maybe you stay inside for a while. People like us, able-bodied men, women should be going to work.
And kids should be going to school.
Absolutely.
And plus, how many people were in there for other reasons but also happened to test positive for COVID? Like, they weren't in the hospital yeah. just for COVID. Maybe they had cancer. Maybe they were in an automobile accident.
And so if you know this early on, if unscientific people like ourselves can look at this and go, hey, there's a pretty big trend here. We think we know what this is and who's most at risk. You should have been focusing on treatments and therapeutics yes. for people who get it, who may be most at risk. And yet he had this bizarro obsession with this vaccine, the same mistake he made with AIDS and HIV. And just like with AIDS and HIV, where a vaccine per se didn't ever really, or at least yet has not become a reality, the vaccine we have now, it's highly ineffective, certainly over the long term.
And they basically lied to us from the very beginning about the vaccine. Remember, this is a pandemic of the unvaccinated.
Yes, right.
Well, Dr. Birx, who was also on the COVID response team under Trump, basically admitted, you know, while promoting her book, that the vaccine they knew from the beginning wasn't going to stop transmission and infection.
And they pushed and emboldened insanity. You guys remember here, I had to take a COVID test every single Friday, even though no symptoms, no signs, no nothing, I'm wasting resources that were valuable, could have been valuable for other people. I'm wasting time that could have been valuable for other people. There was no reason whatsoever for me to take this COVID test. And yet every single week I had to march up there and take a COVID test. It was insane.
So what's more insane? What was taking place in the early stages of COVID when a lot of people started to realize, wait a minute, I don't see people dropping dead in the streets. I don't see all of these things going on. Or a situation like now, where at Notre Dame, they're still making you get the vaccine to enroll in school, even if you're a virtual at-home student. So you it's could insane. Be somebody in your living it's room insanity. By yourself, and Notre Dame is making you get the vaccine, or you can't go to class there.
This is why people like John Fetterman get elected to the United States Senate. I mean, these are the people who vote for John Fetterman. I mean, it is literal sheep who have no critical thinking or free thinking skills whatsoever. This is really on the people that go to Notre Dame, though. Because what if everybody just said no? What if everybody just said, I'm not doing that, I'm standing up for yourselves? And it's easy to go, well, you got to get a degree. I said that here. I was willing to lose my job here. I thought for a while I was going to lose my job here. You have to stand up for yourself if something is so egregious that it is facilitating just utter ridiculous trains of thought, because it infects, that is what infects everybody, is the sheep herd mentality of utter ridiculousness.
And so one of the things that Fauci said during his last press briefing before he rides off into the sunset was you should get tested before Thanksgiving dinner. And I forget how you posed a question, or Casey maybe asked you about it, like what your dad would do to you if you know, before you walk through the threshold of his door, say, Dad, here's a test. Would you mind taking a COVID test real quick before we partake in Thanksgiving dinner? What would he?
My father is a man who has a lot of armory in the house. And as I said, that would be my last Thanksgiving that I'd be experiencing. I mean,
it'd be like that transition scene in those old episodes of The Fresh Prince, where you'd see Will Smith being thrown out of the house. Yeah.
but think about it. He says this with a straight face. As a perfectly healthy person, you should take a COVID test. Does that make any sense to anyone? And he just says it, and he just walks off into the sunset with a rousing round of applause.
How about using some common sense? If you have a fever or a cold or any sort of ailment that you could give to somebody, you have symptoms, you have visible symptoms, I don't care what it is, maybe just stay home and get some leftovers when you can. Is that more of a reasonable thing? If you have symptoms of the flu, I know if I did, I wouldn't be going anywhere. Is that maybe more of a reasonable solution to protecting yourself at Thanksgiving from any sort of illness?
That's the way it's always been.
Yeah, exactly.
It should have always
Such
been that
a
way.
Good point.
It was very creepy Biden whisper.
I did that for dramatic effect. I'm glad you caught on.
I got very strong Joe Biden vibes right there. I wrote the bill on the environment. Frightened the hell out of me, to be honest with you. Rob Kendall is here. A little bonus off the rail segment here as we're off tomorrow. We're off on Friday as well. So I know that Taylor Swift has been a big part of your life, yeah. Rob. Bruce Springsteen and Taylor Swift, they're the same to you. So I heard your rant this morning about this Ticketmaster situation with Taylor Swift.
Oh, yeah.
This has been a big story for the last couple of weeks because I think a lot of these Swifties, as they're known as, her fans, are discovering what a lot of people who have been going to concerts for years have already known. Buying tickets is a miserable experience.
Yes, I am ashamed to admit this, but I have spent more than one mortgage payment now on Taylor Swift tickets over the years.
And it's not because you're a huge fan.
No, the lure of interpersonal relationships with the opposite sex is a strong and expensive thing, my friends. This is ridiculous because she comes out because Ticketmaster is doing, what do they call it, strategic pricing or whatever it is. And basically what the artist got keen to is, look, people are buying these premium tickets, they're relisting them, they're getting all the money.
Right, so people are buying like front row tickets for a Taylor Swift concert for probably $3,000 or $4,000, and they're putting them on the secondary market for like $35,000 to $40,000.
Right. Wow.
And some of these lunatics are paying for it.
And so the artist knew, because Bruce Springsteen was the first one that this came out on, because he kind of did this and his tickets were selling for all sorts of, you know, ridiculous prices. And now it's the same thing happening with Taylor Swift. Well, at least Bruce Springsteen in Rolling Stone came out and said, yeah, we're doing it. We're doing it so that we get paid. Somebody's going to get paid. I don't want it to be the scalper. I want it to be me and my band. Kiss my ass.
And hey, at least she's honest about it.
That's an honest assessment about it. Like, I do this. I have this talent. People want it. Here's what I'm charging. Have a nice day. Taylor Swift comes out and it's like, this is egregious. Someone should do something. Someone should look into this. You looked into it when you signed up for it, you miserable hack. Give me my money back. I wasted on you.
He's rolling. He's rolling. There's a vein sticking out of his neck.
Wow. She plays stupid on this. It's like, you and your people signed up for this and you're the one profiting off of it. You're not giving any of this money back. You're raking in all the money.
She's going to keep all of that money and then she's going to write a song about how horrible Ticketmaster is and make even more money.
And then Congress.
Did I do that right?
That was pretty good, man.
And
that
then
was
Congress,
impressive.
Amy Klobuchar's like, we need to have an investigation into this. 10 years ago or 12 years ago, Ticketmaster had that merger with Live Nation. They've been doing this sort of stuff for years and years and years, but because Congress can't solve any real problems, now they've got to investigate Taylor Swift ticket prices.
So Amy Klobuchar's fine with the fentanyl on the border, but hot damn, bootleg Taylor Swift tickets marked up too high. That's where we have to draw the line.
And the people, the Taylor Swift sheep, are stupid enough to believe this and go, yeah, Taylor's on it. She's really on my side. She's really concerned. She signed the agreement that allows her to make this gajillion dollars. She should totally run for Congress or the presidency or whatever, because she is looking right into society's face and lying to them, and they're lapping it up.
Top three things that have to be on Rob Kendall's plate on Thanksgiving. Like, if something was missing and you'd be highly disappointed if it wasn't there. Top three things on the Rob Kendall Thanksgiving plate.
Free.
Of course. Yeah, expect nothing less.
Someone else prepares it. And minimal effort in the cleanup on my part.
So if someone just brought you a plate full of Pop-Tarts and Hot Pockets, as long as it was free and you didn't make it, you're going to be okay?
You've seen how I live.
Happy Thanksgiving, yeah, happy to you, your lovely wife, your amazing family, and thank you for being part of the Hammer and Nigel
Thanks,
Show.
Thanks, guys.
It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
The latest local news, commentary from Tony Katz, Kendall and Casey, Hammer and Nigel, podcasts. Listen to the station live whenever, wherever, online at WIBC.com.
Yellowstone, television's number one show, is back on Paramount Network.
I, John Dutton, do solemnly swear to uphold the Constitution of the state of Montana against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Featuring an all-star cast led by Academy Award winner Kevin Costner.
The invasion is over.
They will fight you dirty.
Is there any other way?
As the Dutton family fights to protect their legacy, they'll learn power has a price.
Signing this is a declaration of war.
We're already at war.
Yellowstone. New episodes Sundays at 8 p.m. Eastern. Exclusively on Paramount Network.
Yeah, I've been a longtime customer of Window Nation. They installed energy-efficient Window Nation windows in my house, added value to my home, and saved me tons on energy costs, especially at a time when costs are up, inflation is up. Energy costs, highest they've been in 25 years. Save some money with energy-efficient windows from Window Nation, and they have an incredible deal going on right now.
Time is a factor. This deal is about to go away, so even if you're just thinking about getting new windows, take advantage and make the call right now. 866-90-NATION. Buy two windows, get two for free. And there's no limit. It's any style that you want, and you don't pay anything. You don't pay anything until 2025. No down payments, no interest, nothing. Make that phone call right now to lock in saving thousands of dollars. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com, but you have to tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Indianapolis. When you choose Medicare Advantage from United Healthcare, you're with a plan chosen by more people. Medicare Advantage plans from United Healthcare give you more for your Medicare dollar. Get great benefits like dental, vision, and hearing coverage and more. Call United Healthcare at 1-888-CALL-UHC. That's 1-888-CALL-UHC. Benefits, features, and/or devices vary by plan and area. Limitations and exclusions apply. Based on June 2022 CMS enrollment data.
If you run a small business, you need the most from every investment. That's why Comcast Business gives you more. Like more innovation with our new gig speed Wi-Fi, plus unlimited data. More speed from the largest, fastest, reliable network for small businesses. And more savings, up to 60% a year with Comcast Business Mobile. All from the company that powers more businesses than any other provider. When you need more, you need Comcast Business. Powering possibilities.
Get started with internet and advanced security for just $40 per month for 12 months with no annual contract when you add mobile. Plus, ask how to get a $750 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Ends 1-1-2023. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary. Compare pricing of top carriers. Requires EcoBill and AutoPay. Comcast Business Internet required. New Comcast Business 100 megabits per second internet and security edge customers only. Equipment taxes and other fees extra and subject to change. Must add mobile within 90 days of internet install and keep services for 12 months for discount. Results vary. Not an endorsement.
Jamie's log. Progressive. The Harrington's backyard. Day 4. 2:18 a.m. I've been camping outside the Harrington house for 4 days now, proving that Progressive has 24/7 protection. Mr. Harrington says I don't need to do this, since Progressive protects 24/7 is a pretty easy concept to grasp, but I'm going to stay and prove my point. Besides, there's a big tree branch over the roof, and I think it's planning something.
Progressive doesn't just offer a great price when you bundle home and auto. We offer round-the-clock protection. Just not literally from Jamie. Coverage from Progressive Casualty Insurance Company, affiliates, and third-party insurers, and subject to policy terms. Bundle discount not available in all states or situations.
Life is a collection of moments that last forever, so make them matter and make them count with a symbol of everlasting love. A diamond from Pierce Jewelers. Shop local, shop smart, shop Pierce Jewelers.
Tune in Saturdays 9 to 1 for the Home and Garden Show for plenty of advice and fun. Brought to you by Michalis. Water, storms, fire, and foundation. Life happens. Michalis happens to help you through it.
Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep-in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden and Allisonville Home and Garden by Sullivan.
There's a lot of sexy content on the internet. And there's WIBC, full of faces meant for radio. Hammer and Nigel. Kendall and Casey.
Okay, Casey could be on TV.
Now streaming every day on YouTube. Go to youtube.com/WIBC.
Matt Baer has a look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, it is eastbound 465. That is slow from Keystone Avenue over to I-69. Taking a look at Michigan Road, it's been a problem. Still slow both directions into West 79th Street, 79th. A mess around Michigan. I would avoid if you can for a little bit. We did have a crash in that area. East side southbound 465 jams from 72 74. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware. Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep-in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden and Out. Allisonville Home and Garden by Sullivan. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Right now, we've got sunshine 61 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
Shake me down. Not a lot of people left around.
The Hammer and Nigel Show. I think we're getting things set up for a Wednesday edition of Beer Sample Friday here in just a second, right?
We're going to be off the next 2 days, and like hell are we going to skip out on Beer Sample Friday.
No way. So. We'll get to that in just a second. Hammer, once again, provided the libations. Thank you. But we're focusing our attention on Black Friday. Does your wife still get up and go out physically shopping to Black Friday, or is she kind of like Amazon now?
Right? Man, she used to love it. Yeah. It was a thing that her and her mom did, and they bonded, they had fun, they went out early in the morning and got coffees, but it became too violent at times. Like, lunatics in the mall were like beating the hell out of each other.
New from Hammer and Nigel Records, a tribute to exactly what you were talking about, Hammer.
Wreck the malls for a Black Friday score. Fa la 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 la.
Wreck the malls.
Got it.
Doorbusters, you'll bust a jaw for. Fa la 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 la. Ooh. Create some love and hip-hop like drama. Fa la 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 la. To get your kid Bobby the Booty Shaking Llama. Fa la 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 la.
I've seen that.
Bop it like Bobby the Booty Shaking Llama.
Deck some.
Have you seen the Booty Shaking Llama?
I have not seen the Booty Shaking
Very
Llama.
Popular.
Like the UFC. Fa la 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 la. Knock him out for a big screen TV. Fa la 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 la. Scratch and claw for cheap apparel.
La 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 la.
Put it down. I saw it first, Cheryl. La 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 la. La 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 la. Wreck the malls.
There you go.
There it is.
Wreck the malls. A tribute from Hammer Nigel Records for Black Friday. Do we have time for Beer Sample Friday, even though it's Wednesday?
Of course we do.
Right now,
Hammer and Nigel present Beer Sample
Fry.
When?
I got some beers. Let's drink them, huh?
Beer's on sale, people. Come down, get you some.
You just picked this up, right? By the way, our sponsors, Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus. Happy Thanksgiving to Spence and his lovely wife, Heather, and everybody down there working at Thompson Furniture and Mattress.
Take care of those folks, yeah, man, because they support us here on our show.
And they've got a huge Black Friday sale going on, too, right, by the way, down there.
So I walked over to the liquor store earlier today because, honestly, I forgot to bring something from home. You know, it's Wednesday. My mind wasn't right. So all this is something that I don't think we've had yet.
Oh, Dale's Pale Ale.
Yes.
Yeah. Of course. I love Dale's Pale Ale. Oh, you got the 24-ouncer.
I got the big boy here, and it's cold, and it's ready, and I'm upset that it hasn't been opened yet.
I'm sorry.
Now, let me tell you about my experience walking over to Big Red to get this earlier today, Nige. Yep. So this was around 11:30. You know, I'm walking over to the Big Red Liquors downtown Indy, right across from the Winner's Circle.
In Pennsylvania, right?
Correct. Yeah. First of all, on my way there, multiple homeless dudes asked me for a dollar. Well, that's normal. I said no. I kept on going. But on my way back, I'm passing that new Chick-fil-A that opened up right around the corner by Washington Street.
Yeah.
There was a dude who had a bag of food, and he was selling fries individually.
Shut up!
Like they were Taylor Swift tickets or something. I got fries. You get five for a quarter. Five for a quarter.
Did he have any ribs? How much for one rib?
Right.
Like Chris Rock.
I've never seen that before. Like a bag of Chick-fil-A waffle fries, and he was selling them by the fry.
Were there any partakers? Were there any patrons, I guess I should say? Any customers?
No.
Okay, here we go. Thank you. Cheers, man. Happy Thanksgiving. Dale's Pale Ale is the beverage of choice today.
We got more Hammer and Nigel Show. Short show. We wrap it up at 5:30, but we're coming right back. Stick around.
Nobody cares for you like family.
Family Heating and Air.
We set out to be the very best of the best, and past couple years we've actually achieved that. For all of the state of Indiana, we've been awarded the Dealer of the Year award twice now. Unlike other brands, that only gets handed to one dealer every year, and we're very proud to have won that twice.
Put the best to work for you at FamilyHVAC.net. Family Heating and Air is your trusted local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer.
BXG is now open in Indy, baby! Introducing BXG's newest retail store, BXG Indianapolis. Get fitted for hot new PXG golf clubs and our brand new state-of-the-art fitting bays. And shop PXG's off-the-hook apparel, hats, bags, all sorts of stuff. So come by our beautiful new PXG Indianapolis store, 6091 East 82nd Street. We'll be waiting for you. PXG, nobody makes golf clubs the way we do, period.
Yellowstone, television's number one show, is back on Paramount Network.
I, John Dutton, do solemnly swear to uphold the Constitution of the state of Montana against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Featuring an all-star cast led by Academy Award winner Kevin Costner.
The invasion is over.
They will fight you dirty.
Is there any other way?
As the Dutton family fights to protect their legacy, they'll learn power has a price.
Signing this is a declaration of war.
We're already at war.
Yellowstone, new episodes Sundays at 8 p.m. Eastern, exclusively on Paramount Network.
Protecting Hoosiers' health and budget is important. Anthem Blue Cross and Blue Shield can help you do both. 9 out of 10 people in their individual and family health plans qualify for financial help, and some even qualify for $0 premiums. They'll help you find affordable care with no-cost preventive care, $0 commonly prescribed drugs, and free virtual care visits. To learn more, visit anthem.com. Anthem Blue Cross and Blue Shield is the trade name of Anthem Insurance Companies, Inc., independent licensee of the Blue Cross and Blue Shield Association.
Pat Sullivan here for Luminaire. Tired of your kids bringing the creepy crud home from school? Densely packed school buses with dirty air and poor air filtration may be a big part of the problem. A full school bus is like putting 200 kids in a classroom designed for 25. Luminaire's school bus system can solve this problem and provide a clean environment for our children. Let's give our kids clean air on the school bus. Learn more at schoolbusair.com. That's schoolbusair.com.
Coming up in 2 minutes from the Shepherd Community Center studios, your local news from around Indianapolis. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis.
An update coming soon in Idaho. I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. Investigators scheduled to hold a briefing at this hour on the murders of four University of Idaho students stabbed to death 10 days ago in the off-campus house where three of them lived. But in advance of the briefing, they've been knocking down speculation that one of the victims may have had a stalker.
Police say they pursued hundreds of pieces of information related to the possibility that someone was stalking Kaylee Gonsaves. And they say after all that effort, they were not able to verify or identify any stalker.
Fox's Dan Springer in Moscow, Idaho. Police have said two surviving roommates who apparently slept through that attack are not considered suspects. In Colorado, the suspect accused of killing five people at an LGBTQ nightclub last weekend makes a first court appearance facing multiple charges.
The arrest charges were authorized by that PC affidavit were five counts of first-degree murder, which is with intent and deliberation, and then five counts of bias-motivated crimes.
Prosecutor Michael Allen, after Anderson Aldrich appeared by video in a wheelchair a day after getting out of the hospital and was ordered held without bond. Attorneys say the 22-year-old is non-binary, using they-them pronouns. Court records reveal a name change 6 years ago, filed for protection from a father with a criminal history, including domestic violence. They're in shock in Chesapeake, Virginia, where a Walmart employee opened fire on co-workers in a break room last night, killing six before killing himself.
It's a lot to process. You know, these are people in our community whose lives were cut short the day before Thanksgiving. It's heartbreaking.
Dr. Jessica Burgess, an acute care surgeon, treated some of the victims at Centara Norfolk General Hospital. Several people remain hospitalized. Stocks finish higher before a day off tomorrow. The Dow up 97 points at the closing bell. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
What kind of weather to expect tomorrow? Clear skies and 59 degrees in Indianapolis. A few clouds moving tonight with a low of 33. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 4:02. Dry weather continues for today. As for Thanksgiving,
it does look like the rain chances are going to hold off until later in the day. Probably not until the evening hours, with most of the rain falling actually tomorrow night.
Andrew White with the National Weather Service says most places shouldn't get more than a tenth of an inch of rainfall. IMPD says two people were shot this afternoon off North Park Avenue near a Kroger just north of downtown. Police say both people shot are in stable condition but did not identify them. Officers are still investigating. They haven't named any suspects or said what led to the shooting. A man from Arizona was indicted by a federal grand jury after he was accused of threatening, stalking, and harassing a couple from Indianapolis. Prosecutors say Patrick Kearney targeted a woman who refused to date him while they were in college back in the early 2000s. Kearney's accused of sending nearly 24 letters, making over 400 phone calls, and leaving more than 150 voicemails directed at the woman and her partner. Kearney faces 9 charges, one of them stalking. Black Friday deals are already here, but so are scams. Parker Carlson reports what you can do to stay safe from those scammers.
Indiana Attorney General and the Better Business Bureau say that about a third of all frauds come from online scams, and North America is on track to lose up to $380 million this year from them. With Black Friday and Cyber Monday around the corner, you can still stay safe. Be extra cautious when shopping with unfamiliar companies, and some websites are designed to look legitimate but fall apart with further scrutiny. If you have to pay with gift cards or cash apps like Venmo or Zelle, it's best to shop elsewhere. And be sure to report scam attempts or complaints at IndianaConsumer.com. Parker Carlson, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The Indiana Hoosiers men's basketball team is undefeated and ranked 11th in the country. One of the reasons for that is how good their bench has been.
I like our second unit. There's no doubt about that. If they continue to play at a high level like they're playing, man, it just makes us that much better as a basketball team.
IU coach Mike Woodson says that's not a knock on last year's team, but they just didn't have the same kind of production as this year's roster. They play Arkansas Little Rock tonight at 6:30 pregame. Starts at 5:30 on WIBC. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 4:04.
Tickets on sale now for Christmas Nights of Lights at the Indiana State Fairground. Purchase online early to reserve your time slot. Reservations are required. Christmas Nights of Lights is brighter than ever this season, as they have added several new light displays to their show of over 2 miles of driving route. They're excited to reveal one of their most creative and colorful light displays, the Field of Lights. Christmas Nights of Lights is open nightly, all holidays, rain or shine. November 11th through January 1st. They are reservations only, so purchase tickets at ChristmasNightsOfLights.com.
Huber has it.
Huber has all the top brands. Chevy, Buick, GMC, Ford, Acura, Honda, Mazda, Nissan, and more. And every new vehicle includes a 10-year, 200,000-mile warranty. Looking to sell your vehicle? We'll pay you top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Take it from Brooke Huber.
You can get a car anywhere, but you can only get a warranty like this at Huber. 10 years, 200,000 miles.
Visit drivehuber.com.
Huber has it all.
Warranty available on new vehicles except certain models not transferable or available on leases. A copy of the warranty is available for review at the dealership.
But traffic on the fives at 4:05. Here's Matt Bear.
All right, Harrison, looking at eastbound 465 slows. Keystone Avenue over to Allisonville Road. Michigan Road still jacked up going into 79th Street. I'd avoid the area because westbound 79th is also bad from Township Line all the way over to Payne. Nothing good coming out of that intersection here at the moment. Inbound 65 jams 21st Street to the north, a split. Traffic sponsored by Fresh Time Market. This week at Fresh Time Market, save on antibiotic-free, honest, fresh turkey. Just $1.49 a pound now through November 24th. Get real. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And a forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Partly cloudy skies through the night tonight. We'll see lows fall to 34. The skies become mostly cloudy on Thanksgiving. It still remains warm with highs near 57. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
And I'm Harrison Silcox. On the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
You believe these characters are weirdos?
On 93 WIBC.
So let's rock it!
My name is Nigel. Jason Hammer is here. You know, Hammer, one of the things I was most passionate about during the midterms, one of my issues I paid attention to, even in the 2020 election, was energy independence. And with the stroke of a pen after Biden got elected, he signed that debilitating executive order 13990, which effectively ended the Keystone Pipeline, federal oil drilling leases. And people are worried about inflation, the price of goods, the price of food. And all this falls under the umbrella of energy independence. All this falls under the umbrella of the oppressive anti-energy Green New Deal policies of the Biden administration. That brings us to our next guest on the drivehubler.com hotline. Daniel Turner is an energy expert, founder and executive order of Power the Future. Daniel, happy Thanksgiving. How are you?
Happy Thanksgiving. Thanks for having me on, guys. Great to be with you.
So, Daniel, I think I saw you yesterday or the day before on Fox and Friends talking about this. I definitely want to get to your energy policy roadmap for 2023 as the newly elected Congress starts to take power in January. But just a little bit about you, your background. background and what is Power the Future?
Yeah, I've worked in the advocacy space for 20-some-odd years, and I started Power the Future about 4 years ago because I saw a great disconnect between the policymakers and those people who were affected by energy policy. And I live in rural America. We have a sheep and cattle farm. I love rural America. And rural America is where our energy jobs are found, as well as agriculture and so many other jobs, right? But the policy people, the ones who make the decisions about energy policy, are people like Bernie Sanders and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez or Joe Biden. And they make these policies like canceling Keystone, and they're totally disconnected from the millions of men and women who have to suffer the consequences. And I felt that those people needed a voice, so I started this organization exactly for that purpose.
Daniel, Jason Hammer here. Again, for those who haven't paid super close attention, maybe they've been preoccupied with how much things cost in the grocery store, but how dire is the situation with American energy right now?
You know, I hate to be doom and gloom, and it's not fun to have to be, but I'm seriously concerned, and Americans should be concerned. We have a huge energy shortage, and the reason why we have the shortage is because we're not producing enough. And Biden's tried to blame it on COVID. He's tried to blame it on Vladimir Putin. But the fact is, as our supplies have dwindled tremendously, our diesel is what probably has me most concerned because of what machinery, what vehicles use diesel. That's how we power our entire economy. But even home heating fuel is at a very serious shortage, and we're seeing that reflected in prices. So the fact that this administration, that Joe Biden, his spokesperson, KJP, the fact that they're so indifferent, it shows, again, why Power the Future was started. It shows that disconnect between energy policies and their consequences, and those people are out of touch.
And can you compare and contrast the difference between the previous administration and Trump's energy policies compared to what Joe Biden did his first day of office, which was to sign that executive order having to do with the U.S. energy policy?
Yeah, the miracle of the previous administration, of the Trump administration, really the genius of their energy policy, is that they did absolutely nothing. And I mean that in a total compliment. They let us do our job. They got off our backs. They definitely, the president cut an awful lot of regulation. But if we needed permitting, he gave us permitting. If we needed access for land, for pipelines, for drilling, for fracking, whatever, the government allowed it. It's how it should function. And notice the consequence. In 2019, the peak, right before COVID craziness hit, the peak of our energy success, we were producing more oil and gas than ever before. Wow. We were at record low prices nationwide. We had record number of employment in this sector, record number of tax revenue generated by this industry, and we lowered our emissions. If that's the standard that the Greens hold us to, emissions, we lowered our emissions more than any other country in the world. And that's the beauty of the free market. When we were given the chance to operate, we didn't pollute, right? You didn't hear about price gouging under President Trump or profiteering. That's all we talk about now. How come when we had freedom in a free market, we did so much better than the command and control of the Biden? And that's why the left is a danger to freedom and to the economy.
So, Daniel, let's go back a couple weeks with the midterm elections. This was talked about. This was a key point of the conversation in a state like Pennsylvania, where Fetterman went out and has said for years he is against fracking, he's against coal, but yet he still ends up getting elected. What do we make of this?
It's just absolutely devastating, and it shows, well, one, it shows the problem with early elections, as far as I'm concerned, early voting.
Early voting, yeah.
Because, you know, Fetterman was really, his feet were held to the fire after that atrocious debate, and I'm not picking on the guy. But after that debate, then the media began to ask him some really probing questions. And that's when, I believe it was CBS News that showed him the video of him saying how he's always opposed fracking, and him saying, well, that's not true, I support fracking. And a lot of Pennsylvanians were left scratching their heads saying, who the heck did I just vote for? Right? That's the problem with early voting. And that is a strategy of the left right now. Keep your candidates, Joe Biden did it during COVID, right? Keep your candidates hidden in the basement. Use the media to be a shield. Throw lobs at the other team, tell them they're all extremists, they're all racists, they're all MAGA, mega, whatever the phrase was, and let's just hope the voters don't know who our guy is. When I saw what happened in Pennsylvania, it's devastating. Between him and their new governor-elect, Shapiro, They are on the record that they hate the oil and gas industry. And Pennsylvania is the second largest natural gas producer in the nation. 500,000 people work in that industry in Pennsylvania. They have to be nervous.
Energy pro Daniel Turner, founder and executive director of Power of the Future here on the Hammer and Nigel show. What did you think when you saw, because I feel like Joe Biden, every time gas dips below $4 a gallon, there's a victory lap from the White House and they take credit for it. But when gas jumps, they say, well, the president doesn't have anything to do with gas prices. Was there any reason for Joe Biden to deplete the oil reserves?
Yeah, sure. There was a very important reason why he dipped into the strategic reserves. There was a huge emergency, and the emergency was the Democrats were at risk of losing the Senate. And that was the emergency. If we wanted to have an increase in supply, we just need to allow access to oil and gas drilling. But that was not a viable option. So the Biden administration knew if we release these million barrels a day, maybe it will send a market signal. Maybe it will look like the supply is increasing. Maybe the price will drop. Whether or not it did as a mathematical formula, because clearly there's issues with China, there's issues in the global market, doesn't matter. They got the consequence they wanted, which was that he could take credit for looking like he cared, for looking like he was taking action. And it probably did save them a Senate seat or two. And that's tragic, right? We're using this industry as leverage for political ideology. We're using it. And that's not the way we should look at natural gas or oil. It's not the way we should look at farm policy, right? Manufacturing. This is how we survive, how we eat, how we keep ourselves healthy. It's frustrating that we use these great industries for political weaponry. But D.C. is an awful cynical place. It's why I live in rural America.
Daniel Turner, energy expert here on the Hammer and Nigel show. One more thing before we get to the energy policy roadmap for 2023 for Congress that you put out there. I'm wondering what you just thought personally. Like, I thought it was embarrassing as an American citizen to see Joe Biden fist bumping the crown prince of Saudi Arabia, going down there to OPEC with hat in hand, begging them to turn on the spigots and sell us more oil, and then basically giving us the middle finger.
Well, I thought it was embarrassing, especially given his you know, haughty rhetoric about he was going to stand up to this guy and he was going to look him in the eye. I mean, if you're going to make those types of comments, you know, you got to man up, right? If you're it's like the guy in the bar who's threatening to punch everyone's lights out, and then someone stands up and he's like, "Nah, I'm not actually going to fight." Joe Biden spoke with such anger about the Saudis, about OPEC. And don't get me wrong, I am no friend of the Saudis or of OPEC. OPEC's an evil cartel. But you can't have it both ways, Joe, and he seems to want it that way.
Okay, so newly elected Congress, Republicans have the House, take power in January. Your firm, Power the Future, has compiled an energy policy roadmap for 2023, which is like it's basically a top 10 list of things that, if enacted, can help reverse the destruction that's been caused by Biden's anti-energy Green New Deal. Can you just maybe briefly go over some of those, some of the more important highlights on this list?
Sure. And what we really wanted to highlight for the incoming Congress as an advocacy group is that, you didn't flip the Senate. And of course, Biden is still president for two more years. But the House has tremendous power. Look at the committees that impeached President Trump twice. Look at the January 6th committee. Those committee chairs have an awful lot of power. And Nancy Pelosi, say what you want about her, she understood the power of the speaker, the power of the gavel, and she wielded it without any mercy. This roadmap we put together was a guide to say to members of Congress, hey, you're in the House now, you're in the majority, let's start standing up for America's oil and gas industry and maybe punching back. And so we listed 10 very specific things that the House can do. Hopefully they'll heed us.
Where could people find out more on your foundation? Where can people find you if they have questions and want to see this energy policy roadmap, Daniel?
Yeah, powerthefuture.com is our website. It's right there on the homepage. Heck, if people want to email me, I always give out my email, daniel@powerthefuture.com. And if you guys will have me back sometime, maybe they can hear me again on your great program.
Yeah, we would love to have you back very soon, Daniel, for an update. The diesel thing really has me worried the more I read about that. So maybe we can get an update for you here in a couple of weeks. Happy Thanksgiving and best to you and yours.
Thank you so much. Great to be on your program. I appreciate it.
Matt Baer has a look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, looking at Michigan Road. Avoid Michigan at 79. Still backed up, still jammed up. And then coming down from Lebanon, southbound 65, an absolute zoo from the rest area down to 52. That's because of road work. We stop again. Oh, after Lebanon exit 138 down to 267. Yeah, inbound 65 stop and go from 21st to the north split. And now we have a crash State Avenue of Minnesota. Another one, Penn Pike east of 465. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware. Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep-in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden and Allisonville Home and Garden by Sullivan. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Right now, we've got sunshine 61 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
A surprise proposal under the stars. A diamond ring symbolizing your love. A promise to inspire respect and love one another. Visit Chain Company to create a treasure that will hold meaning forever. We design our engagement rings in-house, so any style you choose will be a unique creation. We know a ring comes to life when it's set with a center stone that speaks to you. Chain Company offers the largest selection of center stones, natural diamonds and lab-grown diamonds, as well as natural gemstones, including rubies, sapphires, peach morganite, aquamarine, and amethyst. We sell our center stones loose, so you can compare stones side by side and select the one that's right for you, or select a perfectly preset ring that's ready to go. A jewelry consultant will work with you to help you maximize your budget. Our free lifetime warranty even covers the center stone. Make this the holiday you'll both treasure forever.
Now you have a friend in the jewelry business. Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
There's only one you, and you only have one heart. That's why Franciscan Health is here with the highest level of heart care that's personal, compassionate, and sensitive to your needs. Known for embracing innovative technology and advancements in care, our nationally recognized heart team is committed to helping you protect the only heart you've got. To schedule your appointment with a heart care expert or to get a second opinion, visit franciscanhealth.org/heartcare.
Hey, Dak Prescott here. Why do I choose proven quality sleep from Sleep Number? Because better sleep elevates my game. My Sleep Number 360 smart bed helps me fall asleep faster, keeps me cool, and effortlessly adjusts for my best sleep. That's more focus, more edge, and more highlights. And that means more wins for all of us.
Save 50% on the Sleep Number 360 Limited Edition Smart Bed plus special financing, only for a limited time. Sleep Number, the official sleep and wellness partner of the NFL. Special financing subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.
Get revved up to strike gold with the best ticket deals of the season.
Here's a deep three, Halliburton!
Gold Friday, presented by KeyBank, is your chance to get tickets to some of the biggest games, starting at just $5.
Matherin loads a three. He's got it going!
These deals won't last long. Head to Pacers.com/GoldFriday to get yours.
Tickets to big matchups, including the Miami Heat, available for a limited time. Limited quantity available at Pacers.com/GoldFriday.
Rebates are back. Leasing is back. Order banks are open. Non-commissioned sales staff ready to impress. It's Thanksgiving and it's time to give thanks. Stanley Chevrolet in McCordsville. Every new Chevy below MSRP. GM employee and supplier discounts honored. New inventory is back. Used inventory is back. Every new Chevy below MSRP. We're close, we're easy, and we'll save you a whole lot of money. Stanley Chevrolet in McCordsville is giving thanks for this Thanksgiving. Now through November 30. Excludes Corvette and Z06.
The next time you visit your healthcare provider, we'll ask you about your race, ethnicity, and preferred language. Why do we ask? We ask because we care. Providing you with the highest level of care requires that we know all we can about you. Not only will this help us take better care of you, it will also help us learn more about our community and the additional services we can provide to keep Indiana as healthy as possible. This message is brought to you by Indiana University Health, Eskenazi Health, and Community Health Network.
Amber and Nigel here, inviting you to join us as we kick off the weekend every Friday around 5:45 with Beer Sample Friday, brought to you by our friends at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus.
When the weather turns severe, turn to the WIBC Storm Desk, presented by Technology Recyclers, certified electronics recycling. Visit tech-recyclers.com.
This hour on 93 WIBC is powered by Pierce Jewelers, Carmel's Diamond Engagement Ring Store.
Hammer and Nigel presents
is
It depends upon what the meaning of the word is.
Is this anything?
On 93 WIBC.
Hammer, how do we play Is This Anything?
I'll run a story or two by you. You break down all the information and tell us if the story is anything or not. And we start with this. Somebody's doorbell camera filmed a couple that was showing up for a party, but they had the wrong day.
Oh, no. Like a Thanksgiving party?
Right.
Wow.
Dark in there.
Got a little. Not today, right? Shut up, it's not today. Keep scaring
me. She's been telling me all day.
Oh my god. Next Saturday. Well, you look cute. You want to come in?
Yeah, y'all look great. Y'all want to go to dance or something?
This is going to be so funny.
So it was like a Friendsgiving kind of thing,
yeah.
And they had the wrong date.
They were a week early. She's like, yeah, we got a babysitter and everything. by the way, I know, like, if this were me and my wife, my attitude would be, look, we screwed up, but you got us now. I ain't coming back next week. Let's do something now. We went through the trouble. We got the babysitter. And so it's either now or never. What do you say?
All right. So devil's advocate, I'm the hosts and I answer the door. It's not my fault that you don't understand the topic of dates and times. Have fun tonight, but we've got other plans.
I'm just saying, all right, that's fine, but you're not going to see us next week.
So the whole point of the invitation is to follow the date, dumbass.
That is pretty funny. A week early. You're showing up a week early for a Friendsgiving party. But that's, I'm just saying, that's my attitude. Now, after hearing the couple hired a babysitter, it sounded like they all discussed hanging out anyway, though. So
okay.
It kind of worked out, but... Yeah, what if I had plans the next Saturday that was supposed to be your party?
Well, then I would have expected you anyway, and I sure as hell didn't expect you a week early. Again, it's not my fault that you're a moron.
Okay.
Have you ever been to a party where, like, it was the wrong date or wrong time?
I'm trying to think. Maybe in my 20s when it was, you know, everything was kind of a blur back then, and I didn't write things down, and there wasn't... good communication between me and my other buddies. Yeah, sometimes we'd show at a place and be like, dude, that's tomorrow.
I've showed up for school before when there were days off at school.
Like, I've shown up for work before when we were off.
I've done that too. Yeah.
When we had the day off, had no clue, and I've showed up for work, and they're like, what are you doing here?
We get Columbus Day off? Hot damn! All right!
All right, one more.
But then they pull a U. Well, since you're here.
Yeah. Why don't you go ahead and get behind the soundboard there?
Coming up here in just a moment, Casey Daniels, she's going to slide in here. We call the segment The Side Piece,
yes,
because that's her online blog at WIBC.com, but we're going to have a little fun with Casey, and that's coming up next on the Hammer and Nigel Show.
My husband and I live next door to a haunted graveyard. It's a little creepy, but we manage. Just like we manage without home internet. Do I wish my mobile hotspot was faster? Yes, but I make it work. Kinda. Just like we make it work sleeping next to a 17th century burial ground.
Honey, can you move your hand?
That's not my hand.
It's mine.
Not having home internet? It's not that bad.
It is that bad. Don't settle. Switch to Xfinity and get one line of unlimited mobile and home internet together for $50 a month for 12 months. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit your local Xfinity store today. Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas. New Connect internet customers only on one-year contract. Internet included for 12 months. New Xfinity mobile account required. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. After 12 months, regular rates apply. Xfinity post-pay internet required for Xfinity mobile. Additional devices extra. Reduced speeds after 20 gigabytes of data usage. Offer ends 12/21/22.
Hey, Dak Prescott here. Why do I choose Proven Quality Sleep from Sleep Number? Because better sleep elevates my game. My Sleep Number 360 smart bed helps me fall asleep faster, keeps me cool, and effortlessly adjusts for my best sleep. That's more focus, more edge, and more highlights. And that means more wins for all of us.
Save 50% on the Sleep Number 360 Limited Edition smart bed plus special financing, only for a limited time. Sleep Number, the official sleep and wellness partner of the NFL. Special financing subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.
This year, giving is receiving with Indiana College Choice 529 Savings Plans. It's the tax-advantaged way to save for qualified education expenses at any eligible institution in and out of state, including tech, trade, undergraduate and graduate programs, and registered apprenticeships. Contribute by December 31st, and you could receive a 20% Indiana state tax credit worth up to $1,000. Visit collegechoicedirect.com/plans to get started and read the disclosure booklet carefully before investing.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
What's in your forecast this holiday? 58 degrees and sunny in downtown Indy. Radar's clear. You've got a low of 33 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 428. There's a chance you see some rain Thanksgiving Day.
It's going to be light, but it'll be pretty, equal chances throughout the state. About, most areas will see at least, 1/10 of an inch of rain or so.
Andrew White with the National Weather Service says any rain that does fall will be gone by Friday morning. Highs will stay around 50 each day for the rest of the month. The person suspected of killing 5 and wounding 17 others after a shooting at a gay nightclub in Colorado Springs was in court today in El Paso County. The 22-year-old, who says they are non-binary and uses they-them pronouns, was told of his charges and is being held on suspicion of murder and bias-motivated crimes in connection to the shooting. He's back in court December 6th. States who have opposed the president's student loan forgiveness plan will make their case in a brief to the U.S. Supreme Court. Fox's Grinnell Scott reports.
The 6 states, Arkansas, Iowa, Kansas, Missouri, Nebraska, and South Carolina, say President Biden's effort to forgive student debt is more campaign promise than financial burden relief. The states also argue the action is no longer connected to a national emergency, as the HEROES Act requires. The Biden administration awaits reviews of a lower court ruling preventing forgiveness of up to $20,000 in student loan debt. The White House believes the states don't have standing to argue. Grinnell Scott, Fox News.
7 at Michigan State University football players are being charged with assault for attacking University of Michigan football players after the schools played each other in Ann Arbor October 29th. Video shows MSU players throwing punches and one swinging a helmet at a Michigan player in the stadium's tunnel that leads to the locker rooms. One player, Kerry Crump, has been charged with felony assault. The other 6 were given misdemeanor assault charges. And for your stock report, the Dow was up 95 today to 34,194. NASDAQ was up 110 to 11,285. And the S&P 500 up 23 points to 4,027. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 432.
At Indiana Foundation Service, we work on a lot of neighborhood homes. And we're proud to share some of what our customers have said about us.
My basement had massive amounts of water when it rained. I made an appointment. They were professional and honest. I'd highly recommend them if you need help waterproofing your home. You'll be in good hands.
When we realized our family room was sinking, we knew we had to act fast and get the right people to come out and evaluate our situation. It was nerve-wracking. Turns out I had a foundation problem. They fixed it and guaranteed it for life.
I was having problems with water in my crawl space during heavy rains. I was concerned about mold and the air my family was breathing. I'm so happy I called. The problem was fixed, and I'm not stressed anymore.
Indiana Foundation Service can keep your home and family safe. Visit indianafoundation.com to book your free inspection.
Indiana Foundation Service, reliability from the ground up.
With traffic at 431, here's Matt Bear.
Here's some vehicle temp down heading to Indianapolis from Fishers. It's inbound 69, approaching 82nd. Left lane blocked, backed up to 96. Michigan Road is 79th. I'm still staying clear. We had a crash in that area. Everything is really fouled up at that intersection going in and out of it. Also looking at the east side, southbound 465, stop and go traffic from 70 down to south at Shadeland Avenue. Traffic sponsored by Fresh Time Market. This week at Fresh Time Market, save on sweet potatoes just 27 cents a pound with a digital coupon now through November 24th. Get real. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Partly cloudy skies through the night tonight. We'll see lows fall to 34. The skies become mostly cloudy on Thanksgiving. It still remains warm with highs near 57. I'm Wish TV's Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
And I'm Harrison Silcox, on the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
Nigel. Jason Hammer is here. Casey Daniels from the Kendall and Casey Show in for the side piece. Happy Thanksgiving, Casey. How are you?
Hey, happy Thanksgiving. I'm good. How about you guys?
I'll pose the same question I posed to Rob Kendall earlier. He was stumbling around the studio. He hadn't left yet. Have you ever had to take a COVID test to go to a party?
No.
Like a private party, like a Halloween party or a holiday party, Thanksgiving, nothing?
No.
Not even a request? Not even like an inkling of, hey, we might be doing this?
No.
Because that was Fauci's recommendation for Thanksgiving yesterday at his last press briefing before he, you know, rides off into the sunset.
Yeah, before you go to your family's Thanksgiving, you might want to test. No. The only reason I've ever had to take a COVID test was when I thought I had COVID and for work.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, Nigel, what about you? When you go to those parties where you have to drop your keys in the bowl, do they ask you guys to make sure you've got a negative test with you?
I would not.
Different test.
I would probably forego the test and just turn around and go home, which is where I like to spend most of my time anyway. But I think, generally speaking, maybe if you have a fever or a runny nose or something like that, you stay behind. That would probably
you should probably do that anyway.
Like, that's what runs, yeah, I mean,
you know, if you're not feeling good, maybe don't bring your germs over to the family get together and just sit one out.
But Fauci goes up there yesterday and he's doing his, make sure you've got 18 boosters. Make sure you're testing for this and that. Mm-hmm. But then he's trying to walk off and there's one brave reporter and he's not from the United States. Mm-hmm. And he asks, hey, Dr. Fauci, before you call it a career here, can you answer the million-dollar question?
Right.
And I'm paraphrasing here. Where did COVID come from? What are the origins? You would have thought that the way that the White House press secretary reacted, you would have thought that this dude asked Dr. Fauci, you know, what his favorite sexual position was.
He did. He did ask the question that we all want to know the answer to.
Yeah, where'd it come from? The origins of the COVID. And how pathetic is is Dr. Fauci that he has to have an incompetent boob like KJP in there to step in and kind of protect him and shield him. He's a big boy.
Yeah, she's playing the heavy for him, huh?
Yeah,
he loves to do interviews. He loves magazine covers. He should be able to answer that one last time before he rides off into the sunset.
Oh, no, I'm done. We have a process here. Yeah, the process is we ask questions and instead of deflect or deny or lie or gaslight, you answer the question.
So what are you doing for Thanksgiving? What's the plan? You got? Are you going somewhere?
No.
The daughter is home?
Yeah. She got home this afternoon. So yeah, we're going to, you know, toss that turkey breast into the oven. I didn't buy a full bird. There's only three of us. So we just have a little 6-pounder. Breast.
Are you having random strangers into your house?
No.
I loved Hammer. Did you hear their interview with Jay Query earlier this morning?
Yeah.
Jay Query from 107.5 The Fan, longtime friend of our show, longtime sportscaster, you know, one of the voices of the IMS radio network. Mm-hmm. Tell me what Jake does, because I found your conversation fascinating this morning.
Okay. Well, I don't want to speak for him, but what I got from it was a while ago, years back, he was working at a radio station in St. Louis, and he had to work on Friday, so he wasn't able to come home to Indianapolis for the holiday. And he kind of asked around his coworkers, hey, what are you doing? Hey, what about you? And they all were like, what about you? And he said, oh, yeah, no, I can't go home because I got to work. And nobody invited him over to their Thanksgiving. So he ended up spending it alone. And when he finally did come back to Indianapolis, he said, I don't want this to happen to other people, especially in media, because many times media people are transient, you know, in this market for a few years and then you move on. And so he put it out there when he first started working back in Indianapolis. If anybody's alone, you're welcome to join me.
Not just members of the media, but strangers.
Right. And then
so fans of his show.
He has since elevated it, and he puts his personal phone number out there and text me, DM me. If you are going to be alone, you're welcome to be at my table. And he said that this year they're expecting about 15 people.
Wow. Would any of us in this room consider doing that? You know what I mean? Like, Jake's a really good, selfless guy. He's been through a lot. He had the heart attack.
Yeah.
And I think he's a really thankful, thoughtful guy. I feel... almost inadequate being around it. Like, I feel shameful, like, because I would not do that.
Well, when you speak politics for a living, you never know when somebody's trying to troll you and they want to come into your house and beat the piss out of you.
Yeah, well, that's what
it's
we said.
It's different when you're a sports guy, I think.
Yeah, that would never last for Rob Kendall, because who knows who would show up.
Could you imagine Rob or Tony Katz or, honestly, any of us, some of those tweets that we get, some of those people in the chat houses, these people, like, if we gave out our home phone number, how that would work?
That probably wouldn't go as well as it does for Jake, but isn't that just a generous thing to do? Just open up your home for someone. And yeah, when he was telling the story, it gave me goosebumps, and I think that that's a great thing, and it's cool that we work with someone like that.
Right. My son, by the way, my oldest son, wanted me to ask you, how's hot daughter doing?
Oh, really? Will you tell oldest son that she doesn't have plans tonight?
She's
hanging out.
Wait, she's not. Hold on. She's a college student. She's not going out the night before Thanksgiving with all her buddies.
No, she's a good girl. She's going to hang with her mom.
Now, there's Black Friday. There's Black Friday on Friday, but I heard you guys talking about Blackout Friday, the night before Thanksgiving, generally known as the
Blackout Wednesday.
I'm sorry, Blackout Wednesday, yeah. Which is generally known as the biggest party day of the year, night of the year.
Yeah, followed by like New Year's Eve and St. Patrick's Day and Cinco de Mayo and Halloween all rank up there as big drinking nights.
Back me up, Nige. These are amateur hour days, though.
Yes,
I would say, when I think of amateur hour, the first holiday I think of is New Year's Eve. I think, you know, Blackout Wednesday would fall under that maybe a little bit. Because I think all these kids that are home do it at college anyway. So they're pros.
Yeah, they're triumphantly coming home and going back to the bar and meeting up with all their old high school friends. You know,
back in the day, right, though?
I'm so seasoned, we didn't call it Blackout Wednesday. We didn't have a name for it, right. I think it's like the younger generation at least branded it, so now we all know what it is. What about you? Are you going to participate in Blackout Wednesday?
I participated. I'm going to go home tonight and have a few drinks and sit and hang out with the family, watch some Christmas movies. And
so it's Wednesday. I'm going to have some drinks tonight, like at some sort of big special occasion.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, whatever day. Doesn't have to be Thanksgiving.
Beer sample
for Nigel.
Friday, whiskey Wednesday, tequila Tuesday.
All the time.
I've got a list here, a study of 5 rude things people do on Thanksgiving. I want to know if this resonates.
Like, is number one talk about politics?
Right. That's in there. So 5 rude things people do on Thanksgiving. Bringing something that requires cooking to the dinner.
Oh.
If with food you're bringing requires oven space.
Yeah.
You got to clear it with the host first. Okay. Does that make sense to you or anybody, Hammer?
Yeah, I can see that because you've got all the dishes already in the oven and I could see that.
Starting tense conversations.
Okay, there's the politics. That's where that rolls in.
Politics, religion, family issues. Mm-hmm. You're not changing anyone's opinion ever on Thanksgiving, I wouldn't think, Hammer. Although
am I going to try.
You get into it sometime with some family members, don't you?
Every once in a while.
You have some people with differing opinions in the Hammer clan.
My youngest son, the biggest one of them all. Me and Jacob fight like nobody's business. Little weasel. He doesn't pay for anything. Of course he feels the way that he does.
Top 5 rude things people do on Thanksgiving. Prying into people's personal business. So, when are you having kids?
When are you getting married? When are you having a baby?
What's that smell? Exactly. I've been there a million times.
How about this? Asserting yourself in the kitchen without being asked.
Oh boy.
Uh-oh.
So like if you're helping out in
the look on
great.
Casey's face right now.
Just don't take over and start critiquing the recipes, right?
Let me just tell you, that has happened to me in my past. And you know what? After about the 3rd year, I said, fine, go for it. I'm done.
I'm going to go sit down.
You know, when I was younger, I was offended by that. But now that I'm older, I'm like, wait, where's dinner? When are you guys going to start cooking?
Do you agree with this assessment? I told Nye just a couple weeks ago, if you're going to be the one that makes like the mac and cheese or the really big part of the Thanksgiving meal, you need to have a resume and some experience. I don't want some new person, some college kid coming in there making the mac and cheese or the mashed potatoes. You haven't earned that right yet. I want a, like 5-6 years experience before you can even think about being in charge of that.
So when somebody comes over to the Hammered House, can I see your resume, please?
Right. Oh, you brought mac and cheese. How long have you been cooking?
Right.
Out of the blue box? Is this out of Kraft macaroni and cheese? Because I'm fine with that the rest of the year. I want the real hardcore stuff, though, on Thanksgiving.
I want a block of Velveeta showing up with that mac and cheese.
And finally, the top five rude things people do on Thanksgiving, bringing something that requires cooking, tense conversations, prying into people's personal business, asserting yourself in the kitchen, and then the number five, assuming you can take home leftovers.
Oh.
I have been to other Thanksgivings before at other people's houses where other guests show up with empty Tupperware.
No.
Oh, yeah. Come on. Don't just start loading up your Tupperware.
A full Cousin Eddie taking the bag through the buffet?
Right. Wait for the host to offer them.
Right. Don't they realize that that's your food for the next week?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Casey, God bless you and your family. Thank you so much for being part of our show this year. And we're off the next couple of days. You know, the holiday schedules are crazy. Mm-hmm. But God bless you and your family. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's same to you guys. Happy Thanksgiving.
It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
I'd rather be folding laundry.
This is gonna be fun.
Said no one ever. Also, no one enjoys wasting time in traffic. That's why we love saving you time. Matt Bear Traffic.
Backups are already starting.
On 93 WIBC.
If you run a small business, you need the most from every investment. That's why Comcast Business gives you more. Like more innovation with our new gig speed Wi-Fi. Plus, unlimited data. More speed from the largest, fastest, reliable network for small businesses. And more savings, up to 60% a year with Comcast Business Mobile. All from the company that powers more businesses than any other provider. When you need more, you need Comcast Business. Powering possibilities.
Get started with internet and advanced security for just $40 per month for 12 months with no annual contract when you add mobile. Plus, ask how to get a $750 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Ends 1/1/2023. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary. Compare pricing of top carriers. Requires EcoBill and AutoPay. Comcast Business Internet required. New Comcast Business 100 megabits per second internet and security edge customers only. Equipment taxes and other fees extra and subject to change. Must add mobile within 90 days of internet install and keep services for 12 months for discount. Results vary. Not an endorsement.
You're having a tough time coming up with Christmas gift ideas. Two words, Diamonds Direct, because they're celebrating their holiday season by extending that special 20% savings offer now through this weekend. So start your holiday shopping early and save big. Everything is included. I'm talking about rings, earrings, pendants, bracelets, bands, colored gemstones, and yes, if you're into it, if this is going to be your thing, a winter engagement, they have thousands of engagement rings. Now an extra 20% off through this weekend only at Diamonds Direct, the Keystone at the Crossing.
Don't miss this special extension of Diamonds Direct, biggest and final store-wide sale of the year. It's through this weekend only, so you got to hustle. Save an extra 20% on multi-million dollar inventory of the finest jewelry you will find. You can also get special financing. DiamondsDirect.com or stop by Keystone at the Crossing. Diamonds Direct. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
Yellowstone, television's number one show, is back on Paramount Network.
I, John Dutton, do solemnly swear to uphold the Constitution of the state of Montana against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Featuring an all-star cast led by Academy Award winner Kevin Costner.
The invasion is over.
They will fight you dirty.
Is there any other way?
As the Dutton family fights to protect their legacy, they'll learn power has a price.
Signing this is a declaration of war.
We're already at war.
Yellowstone, new episodes Sundays at 8 p.m. Eastern, exclusively on Paramount Network.
At Landmark Recovery, we know that living life addicted to drugs or alcohol is isolating and empty, especially during the holidays. Do you really want to live life that way? Get help with your addiction to find a more fulfilling way to live life. Reconnect to who you really are and the people who love you most. Get addiction help with Landmark Recovery. Call 866-LANDMARK or visit landmarkrecovery.com today.
PXG is now open in Indy, baby. Introducing PXG's newest retail store, PXG Indianapolis. Get fitted for hot new PXG golf clubs and our brand new state-of-the-art fitting bays. And shop PXG's off-the-hook apparel, hats, bags, all sorts of stuff. So come by our beautiful new PXG Indianapolis store, 6091 East 82nd Street. We'll be waiting for you. PXG, nobody makes golf clubs the way we do, period.
You'll be talking to family and friends on the phone during the holidays, so make sure everyone enjoys the conversation, including those with hearing loss. RelayIndiana.com provides captioned telephones that allow the hard of hearing to have normal phone conversations through voice recognition technology. The other person's words appear on an easy-to-read screen. Don't let those with hearing loss become isolated during the holidays. Get the CapTel captioned telephone from Relay Indiana. Learn more at RelayIndiana.com.
Pierce Jewelers has a spectacular array of diamond earrings, diamond pendants, diamond rings, and diamond bracelets. They shop the world to bring you the very best. Shop local, shop smart, shop Pierce Jewelers.
Complete an application for a refinance or purchase by the end of the year and receive up to $1,000 back at closing. TheHomeLoanExpert.com/Friday.
Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep-in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden and Allisonville Home and Garden by Sullivan.
Hey, we're pretty social people at WIBC. You can find us all over social media. See what we're up to on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, and on YouTube. We're never more than just a away. Just search for 93 WIBC.
Matt Bear with a look at traffic.
All right, looking at inbound 69 stall before 82nd Street. Left lane is closed. We are backed up to 96. East side southbound 465. Stop and go after 72 south at Shadeland. And coming down from Lebanon southbound 65. Stop and go State Road 47 to US 52. That is road work. Traffic sponsored by Sullivan Hardware. Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden in Allisonville, Home and Garden by Solomon. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Right now, we've got sunshine 61 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
Hammer Nigel Show. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Night before Thanksgiving, biggest party night of the year. 27% of people hammer want Thanksgiving moved to a Friday.
Man.
This, according to a new study.
Come on.
Would Thanksgiving, here's the question. Would Thanksgiving be better on a Friday? 27% of Americans say yes. 29% say they only spend Thanksgiving with family out of obligation. 44% of us would skip seeing our family for $1,000. Would you take $1,000? We'll get to the question of moving Thanksgiving here in a second. But if somebody offered you $1,000 cash to skip Thanksgiving and just stay home and watch football by yourself, would you consider it?
Could I do it like any other day? Like, I don't want to miss out on the food. So could I miss out on that Thursday, the official Thanksgiving, but do it like some other date? Because then I'm in.
No, this says, would you skip Thanksgiving with your family for $1,000?
No, because family memories are worth more than $1,000.
Look at you all saying
now, if it were $10,000, we got a ball game. But so can we go back just a minute, though, to these people that want Thanksgiving moved to a Friday? We have to hear this crap at Halloween, too. Well, Halloween should be moved on a weekend so the kids could have fun.
Everybody says that. Yeah.
No, screw that. The holiday falls on the date. It usually doesn't change, right? Thanksgiving's always going to be on that Thursday, the final Thursday of the month, and Halloween will always be on the 31st. Well, you don't get to move it. It's not a floating holiday.
I would assume most of the people that took this survey and that said yes, move it to Friday, have to work on Friday, so they could just lump it with Saturday and Sunday and get a legit three-day weekend. Like our friend Justin, the official mailman of the Hammer Nigel Show. He doesn't have Friday off. It's back to work for him. So I'm sure he would probably be in the category of, yeah, let's move it to Friday so I get a three-day weekend in out of it.
Yeah, but you know what? It's on a Thursday, Justin, so no one's forcing you to be a mailman, although a damn good one.
Let's see here. What time? I think we mentioned this a little bit before, and here's some official stats. 40,000 people voted online. The most popular answer as to what time should Thanksgiving start? between 3 and 4:30 p.m.
That's when the dinner is served, correct? That's what we're asking here?
That is when dinner is served between 3 and 4:30 p.m., according to 40,000 people in a recent survey. You had a really good point, I thought, about starting it at noon or 1 o'clock and then just keeping it going.
Right.
All day long.
The minute that Lions game kicks off, there needs to be food on the table. I get nobody has dinner at noon unless you're like Joe Biden or some 95-year-old person in a nursing home. But Thanksgiving's different. Thanksgiving is an animal. It's an all-day event. It's not just a dinner. It's a festival of food. It's a glorification of gluttonous. And the minute the Lions kick off that game, there needs to be food on the table.
A couple of other questions that were answered in the survey. This is interesting. Should mashed potatoes be completely smooth or have a few lumps? I'm not the biggest fan of lumpy mashed potatoes, I'll be honest with you.
I'm not either. I kind of like them smooth. I don't want them runny. Let's not get it twisted
not
here.
Runny, but the winner is lumps, actually. 62% of the vote said you got to have lumps in the mashed potatoes. Along those same lines, do you like your gravy smooth or with stuff like mushrooms and onions mixed in?
Oh, smooth gravy. Smooth gravy. And because I'm a fatty, I don't want it just on the mashed potatoes. I want it on the gravy. I want it on the stuffing. I want it on the rolls.
Do we have time for one more here?
Yeah.
Is it okay to play Christmas music on Thanksgiving? 52% say yes.
Folks at B105 feel like it's fine to start it on the Monday before Thanksgiving, so who are we to say that they're wrong?
Apple pie or pumpkin pie? Real quick, you can only have one.
Pumpkin with a massive amount of cool whip.
More Hammer and Nigel coming up just a few minutes, 93 WIBC.
When you start going down this idea that the people you disagree with aren't human, the rhetoric, the dehumanization leads to disaster. It leads to violence. It leads to bloodshed. The people who want to scream anybody they disagree with is a Nazi, that's the dehumanizing. That's a real issue. I think everyone needs a bourbon and needs to calm down.
Tony Katz, mornings 6 to 9 on 93 WIPC and WIPC.com.
Listen right here this weekend to Everyday Wealth with Soledad O'Brien and Gene Chatsky, presented by Edelman Financial Engines. For airtimes, visit EverydayWealth.com.
Did you know that you need to winterize your roof? Let Moss Roofing be your first call. MossRoofing.com. Call Moss Roofing before winter hits. Damaged siding can create one big winter project that you do not want to deal with, especially in that frigid cold. Moss Roofing can inspect, repair, or replace damaged siding. They can also recommend downspout extensions or top-notch gutter guards if they see any red flags during the inspection. Let's talk insulation. Investing in and reinforcing your home's insulation with Moss Roofing can reduce your energy bills and keep you warmer this winter. Whether you need to install new insulation or replace your existing insulation, you can always turn to Moss Roofing. Moss Roofing will find the solution that works best for you and your budget. The expert inspectors from Moss Roofing can identify your unique needs. Whether you need winter-ready insulation, gutters, repairs, or a replacement, the Moss Roofing team will come up with a custom winterizing plan for you. Visit MossRoofing.com to get your winter prep started today.
get revved up to strike gold with the best ticket deals of the season.
Here's a deep three, Halliburton.
Gold Friday, presented by KeyBank, is your chance to get tickets to some of the biggest games, starting at just $5.
Mathurin loads a three. He's got it going.
These deals won't last long. Head to Pacers.com/GoldFriday to get yours.
Tickets to big matchups, including the Miami Heat, available for a limited time. Limited quantity available at Pacers.com/GoldFriday.
Protecting Hoosiers' health and budget is important. Anthem Blue Cross and Blue Shield can help you do both. 9 out of 10 people in their individual and family health plans qualify for financial help, and some even qualify for $0 premiums. They'll help you find affordable care with no-cost preventive care, $0 commonly prescribed drugs, and free virtual care visits. To learn more, visit anthem.com. Anthem Blue Cross and Blue Shield is the trade name of Anthem Insurance Companies, Inc., independent licensee of the Blue Cross and Blue Shield Association.
The best part about taking ZzzQuil Pure Z's Sleep Plus Next Day Energy at night is actually the next morning. I wake up alert with none of the grogginess from taking too much melatonin. Pure Z Sleep Plus Next Day Energy is a bilayer tablet with immediate release melatonin and extended release B vitamins to help me fall asleep naturally and wake refreshed. It's my secret weapon for a great night's sleep and a great morning.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
Can't beat that.
ZzzQuil Pure Z's Gummies. Sleep better, wake your best.
Hey, Pat Sullivan here, and the holidays are around the corner, which means tons of food, lots of family and guests in your home, and clogged drains. Don't let your backed up pipes ruin the holiday spirit. Call my friends at Hope Plumbing, and they'll make sure to keep everything flowing. Visit hopeplumbing.com for a $49 mainline cleaning and an $89 small drain cleaning. So the next time you need a plumber, let Hope Plumbing take care of the dirty work so you can get back to your holiday fun.
Looking for the perfect gift this holiday? Crew Car Wash books are on everyone's list. And right now, buy 4 Ultimate Washes and get 2 free. Available online or at any Crew Car Wash location. Plus, get a free bonus wash now through November 30th.
The next time you visit your healthcare provider, we'll ask you about your race, ethnicity, and preferred language. Why do we ask? We ask because we care. Providing you with the highest level of care requires that we know all we can about you. Not only will this help us take better care of you, it will also help us learn more about our community and the additional services we can provide to keep Indiana as healthy as possible. This message is brought to you by Indiana University Health, Eskenazi Health, and Community Health Network.
Coming up in 2 minutes, why you might be getting some rain on Thanksgiving Day. Indy police are investigating after 2 people were found shot this afternoon north of downtown. And Parker Carlson reports on the human remains that were ID'd in Northwest Indiana. That's coming up after Fox News Radio from the Shepherd Community Center studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 5 o'clock.
Breakthroughs in a terrifying tragedy. Lisa Brady, Fox News. 10 days after 4 university students were stabbed to death in Moscow, Idaho, in the home where 3 of them lived.
No suspects have been named or arrested, and we continue looking for what we believe to be a fixed blade knife used in the murders.
Moscow Police Captain Roger Lanier says they're still looking into reports that one of the victims had said she might have a stalker. So far, nothing found to verify that. Police also say they did consider a murder-suicide early in the investigation, but are not considering that now. And they've ruled out a variety of people who were with the victims that night, including 2 surviving roommates believed to have slept through the attack.
Moscow's my home.
Deputy City Supervisor Tyler Palmer fighting back tears as he said Moscow won't be defined by the tragedy, but how they respond to it.
We mourn the loss of these beautiful young people, and we will relentlessly pursue justice on their behalf.
After Thanksgiving break, the University of Idaho president says students can finish the semester either in person or online, and they're planning to hold a memorial service next Wednesday. Witnesses say a Walmart manager said nothing as he opened fire in a break room last night in Chesapeake, Virginia, killing 6 people before he was killed, an apparent suicide. Police still investigating a motive. The manager had worked for Walmart since 2010. 10. The latest in a string of mass shootings, including the attack Saturday night at a gay nightclub in Colorado. The suspect, Anderson Aldrich, making a first court appearance.
The suspect is facing 5 counts of first-degree murder and 5 counts of what's essentially a hate crime in Colorado. But those are just the preliminary charges, and additional charges could be filed over the next couple of weeks.
Fox's Garrett Tenney. Attorneys say the 22-year-old suspect identifies as binary. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
What's in your forecast this holiday? Mostly sunny, 57 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. Radar's clear, a low of 33 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 5:02. You could be getting some rain Thanksgiving night.
It's going to be light, but it'll be pretty, you know, equal chances throughout the state. About, you know, most areas will see at least, you know, 1/10 of an inch of rain or so.
Andrew White with the National Weather Service in Indianapolis says any rain that does fall will be gone by Friday morning. He says high temperatures will continue to be near 50 degrees for the rest of the month. IMPD says two people were shot this afternoon off North Park Avenue near a Kroger just north of downtown. Police say both people shot are in stable condition, but they did not identify them. Officers are still investigating and have not named any suspects or said what led to the shooting. Duck hunters discovered human remains last month. Now investigators have a name for the person found. Parker Carlson reports.
The body was identified as Dushana Glover, a woman who had been missing for over 2 years. October 22nd, duck hunters in Griffith found bones sticking up from the marsh under clothing. After police came and confirmed that they were human, the sheriff's dive team began to search the area and found more remains. The Northwest Indiana Times reported Tuesday that the Lake County coroner identified the body as Glover, and while the investigation is still ongoing, they don't suspect foul play. Parker Carlson, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
For the 11th ranked Indiana Hoosier men's basketball team, forward Trace Jackson Davis has been picked to be the Big Ten Player of the Year, which means he draws a lot of attention from opponents.
You know, and it's something that we go over every day based on where we think teams are going to trap him.
IU men's basketball coach Mike Woodson. The Hoosiers play Arkansas Little Rock tonight at 6:30. Pregame coverage can be heard on WIBC in about half an hour. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 5:04.
Yellowstone, television's number one show, is back on Paramount Network.
I, John Dutton, do solemnly swear to uphold the Constitution of the state of Montana against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Featuring an all-star cast led by Academy Award winner Kevin Costner.
The invasion is over.
They will fight you dirty.
Is there any other way?
As the Dutton family fights to protect their legacy, they'll learn power has a price.
Signing this is a declaration of war.
We're already at war.
Yellowstone. New episodes Sundays at 8 p.m. Eastern, exclusively on Paramount Network.
Hubler has all the top brands. Chevy, Buick, GMC, Ford, Acura, Honda, Mazda, Nissan, and more. And every new vehicle includes a 10-year, 200,000-mile warranty. Looking to sell your vehicle? We'll pay you top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Take it from Brooke Hubler.
You can get a car anywhere, but you can only get a warranty like this at Hubler. 10 years, 200,000 miles.
Visit drivehubler.com.
Hubler has it all.
Warranty available on new vehicles except certain models not transferable or available on leases. A copy of the warranty is available for review at the dealership.
With traffic on the fives at 5:05, here's Matt Baer.
Inbound 69, it's still there. The stall in the left lane at 82nd Street, backing us up to East 96. And then on the east side, southbound 465, slow roll from 70 down to 74. I'm still out of commission at 79th and Michigan Road. Not going near that for the moment. There was a crash in the area, and everything into the intersection is dragging big time. And then we have a crash. It's Penn Pike, east of 465, car against a pedestrian. Traffic's sponsored by Sullivan Hardware. Remember to sleep in Friday morning because the sleep-in sale starts Friday at 10 a.m. at Sullivan Hardware and Garden at Allisonville Home and Garden by Sullivan. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Partly cloudy skies through the night tonight. We'll see lows fall to 34. The skies become mostly cloudy on Thanksgiving. It still remains warm with highs near 57. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Tara Hastings for 93 WIBC.
And I'm Harrison Silcox. On the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
You believe these characters
are weirdos?
On 93 WIBC.
So let's rock it!
Happy Thanksgiving to you and yours. My name is Nigel. Jason Hammer is here. We'll bring on one of our favorite special guests to kick off the hour, Tony Kinnett. is an education journalist, former STEM administrator for IPS. Tony, happy Thanksgiving, or happy Thanksgiving Eve, however you want to put it. How are you?
I'm doing excellent, gentlemen. Happy Thanksgiving Eve to both of you as well.
You know, like I saw you tweet out something from an article that said educators, here's the quote, educators overwhelmingly say the teaching social emotional skills in the classroom is helpful for students' career readiness. First of all, social emotional learning, what is that? And is it kind of akin to, is it a fancy way of saying critical race theory? Do I have that wrong or right, or what is that?
Social emotional learning can mean a lot of different things. This is kind of the first trap that people kind of fall into when discussing it. Social emotional learning is really just taking time away from academics to discuss basically how your subjectivity needs to be sensitive to others, how you should express your feelings, how you should consider different things whenever you're talking about really anything in the environment, in the workplace, anything in society, but through a more progressive lens of just how it makes you feel and you know, what it's all about at the end of the day when we all get in our hugging circle.
That's and that really helps us with math and English. How, Tony? How does that help us with math and English?
Well, for the math and English teachers that don't waste their time on it, it makes for a really great break room conversation. So that's really all it's good for, is something to laugh at. It does not actually show to be anything better for students' mental health other than self-fulfilling prophecy. When we actually pair a student who has had social emotional training, which, by the way, there's actually no standard for, there's not actually any set series of instructional materials outside of the corporations that are making a boatload off of selling the different identity wheels and friendship circles and bracelet making trends. By the way, that's all curriculum in the graduate classes at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. I'm not making any of that up.
Did you say identity wheels?
Oh, yeah, the identity wheel, you know, all of the things that make up who you are, like your race, your religion, what kind of house you grew up in, what gender you identify as, you know, common things you should discuss with
a
third grader.
So $35,000 a year or whatever it is to go to Wisconsin for a year of tuition, and you're getting the identity wheel.
Oh, yeah. So you can take it and teach your students with it. That's what third graders need to read and do math. You know, they need to talk about what skin tone they have and how it impacts their religion, socioeconomic status.
So, I mean, this what we're all talking about here, this headline, educators overwhelmingly say the teacher's social emotional skills in the classroom is helpful for students' career readiness. This is in a major publication, Education Week. And so is that an accurate statement? Do you feel as an educator, as someone that worked as a STEM administrator at IPS, do educators overwhelmingly say this?
Well, it's one of those things where, have you guys ever seen an advertisement where they make some kind of a claim, but there's a little asterisk up at the top right, and then there's a really small line of text at the bottom that says, well, it's not that big. In this case, they asked a bunch of progressive teachers, and they asked those who were union members of the NEA, of the AFT, and they asked them, okay, teachers, who we already know are very progressive, do you like these progressive things? And then they all went, yes, of course. And then everyone cheered, and, you know, they broke out the Little Caesars at the office. And I'm not really seeing any evidence, though, of teachers that aren't a part of the union that don't use social emotional learning, that don't institute that in their schools. I don't see any of them also saying, yeah, it's really helpful. We think it's really effective. The data is just not there.
Well, is there any version of this? Because they make it sound like it's a good thing with the headline. Is there any version of SEL that is beneficiary?
Yeah, absolutely. Telling a kid that, hey, maybe instead of, you know, throwing your fist in through a plate glass window, maybe you actually have a conversation. That's not harmful at all. There's no situation in which, you know, communication and understanding why you feel the way that you do is, you know, there's no situation in which that's a bad part of development. I just believe, and a lot of other classical educators believe, that that is the role of the parent to teach that to the child, not some bachelor's degree from Ball State who's 23 and she has a mission to be mommy in the classroom. That's not her job.
Tony Kennett joining us. And again, he's appearing on the drivehubler.com hotline. You put this out on Twitter. Of course, educators are going to overwhelmingly say that teaching the social emotional learning is helpful. Well, if you're a super woke 20-something year old teacher, you're going to say that. Your response on Twitter was, breaking news, Baskin Robbins overwhelmingly recommends eating ice cream every day as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think of this as a STEM teacher. Someone used to ask me how important computer science classrooms and things like that were. And my answer was, oh, they're very important, because I spent all of my day understanding, you know, computer science and classrooms and that when I was a STEM administrator with IPS. Computer science was one of the things I was in charge of. So, of course, you're going to find people who really like social emotional learning. They're going to be like, oh, yeah, this is extremely necessary. It helps with career readiness, which of all of the things they could have said emotional well-being. They could have said mental stability. They would have had a thin argument, but they would have had an argument. Career readiness, though, I think that if I show up on a job site, my ability to do quick mathematical measurements and weld is going to be more effective than sharing my pronouns and giving out free hugs.
And I always like to throw out this disclaimer. I think the majority of the teachers, first of all, teachers are not the teachers' unions. I think there's clearly a separation there. And I mean, the teachers that I know, the teachers that Hammer knows, that educate their kids, are really good.
I know some lunatics, you know, though, too. Don't get it twisted. I know some absolute freaks. Course.
So I just want to throw that out there, that not all we're not saying all teachers. The teachers we have are great. But you mentioned the unions. You mentioned, and that makes me always think of Randy Weingarten. And I saw is she in some feud with Pompeo, Secretary Pompeo? What is this? He called her, quote, the most dangerous person.
So Randy Weingarten kind of picks a random Republican or conservative or person not on the left to go to war with about once every couple of weeks, once she's forgotten how badly she was beaten the last time she tried. But yeah, this time she's complaining and saying, well, actually, it was the Trump administration that was really bad for students, and the teachers unions were desperately advocating to get kids back into schools. And it was all of these red state Republicans that were causing kids all of this mental stress.
What?
As though none of us remember that the Chicago Teachers Union said that reopening schools was rooted in white supremacy and racism.
Oh.
Or forgetting all of the other teachers unions around the country that went on strike, that actually walked out of the building instead of teaching kids again. All of the teachers unions, remember the group that went down to, what was it, the Bahamas or Aruba or something?
Yeah, she was from Chicago, I think.
Yeah, it's this kind of nonsense that we're supposed to forget, so that Randy Weingarten can get up and act like, you know, the bleeding martyr, as though she's cared about kids all this time, when the evidence suggests otherwise.
Two things on Randy Weingarten. Number one, I'm surprised that the war in Ukraine is still going on, because Randy Weingarten went over there about a month or so ago, taking the teachers' union money to go over to Ukraine for a photo op. I'm shocked that didn't have any effect on what's going on. And number two, I've said this before, tell me if I'm wrong, I've never seen Randy Weingarten and Joe Namath in the same room together. I'm convinced they're the same person.
To answer the first question, there are a lot of teachers in Indiana that are members of the AFT, two very close friends of mine, indeed, still are members of the AFT, and they spend hundreds of dollars a year, and they think it's to, you know, give themselves protection, to make sure they have benefits, but instead it's, you know, paying for Randy's plane ticket to fly to wherever and impersonate Gandhi or whoever else she thinks that she is. And I look at her jowls jiggling on national television, and she tells us that, you know, something is deeply wrong with the American education system from Ukraine. I don't understand the correlation. I don't think she understands the correlation. But hey, you know, if you want to go sightseeing and you have the money, I guess that's your choice.
What's the plan for Thanksgiving, man? And what are the three items that have to be on your plate Thanksgiving Day? No question, you can't live without these foods on your plate on Thanksgiving.
So number one, my grandmother Mary's stuffing. That's right. When it comes to Thanksgiving, if Nana's stuffing is not on the table, it's not Thanksgiving. That's the truth. And she's listening. So there you go, Nana. There's your shout out. Number two, I am a guy who abandons turkey. I think roast chicken is infinitely better.
Oh, so you hate America. That's what we've learned. You hate America.
Yeah, well, after we set fire to the American flag, we usually have Thanksgiving. So.
All right, man. Hey, have a happy and safe Thanksgiving. Thanks so much for coming on our show.
Yeah, man,
tell the family
it.
We said hello, and we'll talk to you soon.
Absolutely. Thanks, guys. Have a Merry Thanksgiving.
Matt Bear's got a look at the roads.
All right, we're on the west side. It is a crash northbound 465 at Rockville Road, 36 right lane blocked, slow back to Washington. Inbound 69 left lane blocked at 82nd Street because of a stall. Traffic sponsored by Mattress Firm. Don't miss the Black Friday sales. Shop Tempur-Pedic to save up to $500 on select adjustable mattress sets and get a $300 instant gift good towards sleep accessories. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us on Twitter for instant traffic updates. Set WIBC traffic.
57 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center at 93 WIBC.
Hey, Dak Prescott here. Why do I choose proven quality sleep from Sleep Number? Because better sleep elevates my game. My Sleep Number 360 smart bed helps me fall asleep faster, keeps me cool, and effortlessly adjusts for my best sleep. That's more focus, more edge, and more highlights. And that means more wins for all of us.
Save 50% on the Sleep Number 360 Limited Edition Smart Bed plus special financing, only for a limited time. Sleep Number, the official sleep and wellness partner of the NFL. Special financing subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.
Hammer Nigel Show, what's going on? I'm an American Standard heating and air conditioning customer, so is Hammer, and here he is to tell you about one of those fantastic local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealers.
How about Marshall Mechanical Heating and Cooling in Franklin? You can make a difference. Marshall Mechanical Heating and Cooling, your local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer in Johnson County, cordially inviting customers and the community to join them to a big donating event for the Good Cheer Fund of Johnson County. Marshall will donate $10 for every service call through December 12th. The Marshall team will also be collecting monetary and canned food donations and assisting with basket stuffing and delivery. Support your neighbors in need with Good Cheer. Schedule your next service appointment at callthemarshallnow.com. That's callthemarshallnow.com. Marshall Mechanical Heating and Cooling in Franklin, your trusted American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer in Johnson County. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
If today were the last day of your life, would you want to do what you're about to do today? As time marches on, the inescapable movement of the clock can change our perspective on life and our daily purpose. We all get there someday. In recent years, families I work with often ask, "What happens to me, Brian, if something happens to you or you decide to retire?" Every day I ask myself, does this still feel like a purpose that I look forward to, or is this starting to feel like a job? This is Brian Singer with Singer Financial. I feel blessed to still love what I do, but someday my purpose might shift to playing pickleball 24/7. CNBC reports that 73% of financial advisors lack a formal succession plan. That means that nearly 3 out of 4 advisors may be contemplating their own retirement with no transitional support for the clients who may have trusted them for years or decades. Fiduciary advisors put clients' best interests first. At Singer Financial, that means knowing how the individuals, couples, and families we work with will be taken care of for many more years beyond my retirement, unexpected disability, or death. Great things in business are never done by one person. They're done by a team of people. I'm excited to share that Singer Financial is now a part of Howard Bailey Financial, an Indiana-based retirement planning firm. We believe our integration with the Howard Bailey team is a giant step forward in our mission to be the last financial team you would ever need or want. Howard Bailey is a growing firm with a youthful, energetic founder and a cutting-edge planning process designed to help you transition into a work-optional lifestyle someday. Call us at 317-852-9153 to schedule a discovery visit and talk about your someday. If you're ready to plan for your best retirement, we should get together.
Investment advisory services offered through registered investment advisors Howard Bailey Securities, LLC, and AE Wealth Management, LLC. Working with Singer Financial cannot guarantee investment success or that specific financial goals will be achieved.
Dell Technologies Black Friday starts now with up to 50% off select business PCs powered by 12th Gen Intel Core processors. Call 877-ASK-DELL.
Inside Indiana Business Radio, the news you need to get ahead. Indiana's business news leader, weekdays at 6:32 a.m. and 5:56 p.m. on WIBC.
This hour on 93 WIBC is powered by Pierce Jewelers, Carmel's diamond fashion store.
Ah, jeez, you guys are freaking me out!
The Hammer and Nigel Show.
Stop it!
Ow. 93 WIBC.
My name is Nigel. Hammer's over there with a very special and lovely guest on the drivehubler.com hotline.
She saves you money. She is the crazy coupon lady. My better half, Miss Crystal Hammer.
Hey, Crystal.
How are you, love?
I'm good. How are you guys doing today?
She's the crazy Christmas decoration lady as well.
Yes.
At your household.
Very much exactly. The crazy Christmas lady. I told everybody the other day that we'd watched the sequel to A Christmas Story, A Christmas Story Christmas, and I don't want to spoil it, no spoilers, but I told Nigel that it's more of an emotional movie than it is a funny movie. Is that a fair assessment?
I think so, because I know I cried several times throughout it.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, but you, like, cried during The Simpsons, and, like, you cried during Family Guy.
No, because I can see Ralphie as being the type, like, Christopher, who's all into the Christmas spirit, and then Jacob's Randy, who lives overseas, you know, and I'm not going to give up anymore, but, I saw our family in it.
Do you agree with Hammer's assessment that the original Christmas Story is actually not a Christmas movie, but an action flick?
No, I don't agree with that at all.
All right, so let me make the case here. And again,
restate your case.
Because if I told you there's a movie that features fighting, blood, swearing, somebody almost loses a tongue, somebody almost loses an eye, you would say, oh my God, what an amazing action flick. There's gunplay, somebody gets shot. You would think that's a Stallone movie.
There's cussing.
You would think that's a Bruce Willis or a Schwarzenegger movie. But no, all of those things happen in the first Christmas Story.
But what you leave out is the fact that all this is done by, like, 13-year-old kids. And it's a BB gun, not a real gun. So, no, it's not an action movie.
Oh, so there's a limitation on what's action and what's not because of your age? Because I saw the movie Kick-Ass, and those kids, they put on an action-packed film, Crystal.
I'm not arguing with you.
That's a good movie. I forgot about that movie. That's the Nicolas Cage movie, right? Love that movie. That's a great point.
Yes, yeah. I forgot about that movie, too.
All right, so in addition to being the coupon lady, we're going to get to your deals in a minute, because we challenged you with finding us some booze for Thanksgiving.
Oh.
That was your task.
Yep.
Before we get there, how's the house coming along?
It's coming along. We've got the two trees up in the front room. The tree in our bedroom's up. The patriotic room has its two trees up, which they are red, white, and blue trees, which are awesome. We still have some outside lights we have to do and two more trees to put up in Christopher's room. So my plan with my deal that I did today is to get you pretty liquored up this weekend. That way you're not a pain in my ass. All
get him up on the roof after about a bottle of tequila. I'd like to see him pull a Clark Griswold.
The roof lights are done.
What? I know what I was going to say. I saw Crystal's post on Facebook about her office cubicle. How much time? She wrapped it in wrapping paper.
Basically.
Right. You know what I'm talking about? Did you take up company time to do that, Crystal?
Okay, so...
That's a yes.
No.
That's a yes.
I mean, it is decked out in her cubicle.
No, our computer system actually was down, and that's when I did it. But it's not wrapping paper. It's actually a tablecloth with a brick print to make it look like brick wall.
Like a fireplace or something like that.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But you just happened to have that on standby in the event that the computer was going to go down.
No, I had it at my desk for when I could decorate.
Is there anybody else in your office with the display, you know, comparable to you, to your display at your cubicle?
No.
No way. There's no way.
It's coming this weekend. I know they're getting ready to do a big, major overhaul of our office area.
You are the Clark Griswold of your office.
You
like, I'm surprised there isn't like the glowing lights that's burning up all the energy when you walk in and go to work.
All my lights are battery operated.
Let's go back a week ago. We said, all right, Crazy Coupon Lady, it's Thanksgiving. We need some booze because if we're going to be around the family, if we're going to be eating and watching football, we need some booze. That was your challenge.
And we need a discount on it.
And we need a discount on it. What did you find?
Okay, well, I sent you in with a package for you to open up.
Okay, I've got it. I've got it.
Oh, I didn't see that. What is that?
All right, so first... Oh, first, Crystal, I see this bottle of Svedka Strawberry Lemonade Vodka.
Oh, hello.
Yep.
Crystal, sending the hammer of the good stuff.
Next, I see a bottle of Fistful of Bourbon.
Oh, you've given us a bottle of that before. Yeah.
Yep.
I see Svedka Infusions Ginger Lime Vodka.
That's for the healthy people, because I believe that's sugar-free.
Oh, sugar-free. Okay. For the healthy raging sugar, alcoholic in your family.
Right.
And I've also got a Svedka Cherry Limeade flavored vodka.
Dude.
So we got three bottles of vodka here, one of them sugar-free, and we got a fistful of bourbon here.
Okay. So just out, no coupons or store, sales or anything. What do you think that those four bottles would cost?
Let's see.
Like anywhere from $60 to $80.
I was going to say $65.
Okay. So, yeah, that would have been the retail price on that. And I actually got all three of those bottles. You ready for this? For $38.96.
Oh.
So we got four bottles here. So,
yes.
Which three bottles?
So, the vodka, I got all these bottles at Meijer's, just so you guys know. I got them all from Meijer's. We'll start with the vodka. They are regularly priced. I got to look back at my receipt here. I believe they were $8.99 on sale, but then Ibotta had a rebate where you get $1.50 back per bottle. And if you bought up to three, you got an additional 50 cents off with an Ibotta bonus.
Okay, so they were already on sale for $8.99, which is good alone, but with your Ibotta deals, you cut that down even more.
Yes, I cut it down to basically $7.49,
nice
I believe.
Nice job.
And the fistful of bourbon, you've provided this before, and what kind of deal was this?
The fistful of bourbon, the regular price on that was $29.99. It was on sale already at Meijer's for $22.99, but Ibotta had a rebate for $6 back. So that made it...
Mission accomplished here for the crazy coupon lady. That's impressive because I didn't really think... I didn't think because it's alcohol, because you could always charge a premium for whatever it is unless it's the really cheap stuff. And I don't know that Svedka's, the highest premium vodka out there, but dude, that's perfect for if you're going to a Friendsgiving or a party of any kind, a holiday party,
right?
And so you could take a Sprite and use that as a mixer for any one of these things.
And you couldn't tell the difference if it was Svedka or if it's Smirnoff or if it was Grey Goose,
right?
And right now, if you go to Kroger's, I believe they have Sprite 12 packs. For $12.99, which is a great deal on pop. So you could go get your pop and you got your vodka, and there you go.
And one of these is a sugar-free Svedka. This is the ginger lime, zero sugar. So if you get like the Sprite Zero, you could be healthy and still get your buzz on Thanksgiving.
Right.
You are the best. Crazy Coupon Lady, thank you very much.
Happy Thanksgiving.
All right, Big Nights, we've got IU basketball, the Hoosiers in action. Don Fisher on the call. That is coming up next, right here on 93 WIBC.
On the CareSource Radio Network, from Learfield, this is Indiana Hoosier Basketball, brought to you by Central Indiana Honda Dealers. Your Central Indiana Honda Dealers are proud supporters of IU Athletics. And by Green & Schultz Trial Lawyers, a winning team for victims of injury and loss. More at greenschultz.com. Now, from the Smithville Broadcast Center, this is Hoosier Pregame. Here's the voice of the Hoosiers, Don Fisher.
From Branch McCracken Court in the Simon Scott Assembly Hall on the IU campus in Bloomington, this is Indiana University basketball. This evening, the Hoosiers go after a fifth straight victory tonight to start the season and the second in this year's Hoosier Classic as they welcome the Trojans from the University of Arkansas, Little Rock. Hello again, everybody. Don Fisher here along with Eric Suhr and John Herrick. Indiana moved up to the 11th spot on the early season top 25 rankings this week with a pair of wins over the weekend, beating Xavier last Friday and the Miami Redhawks on Sunday in Indianapolis, 86-56. IU continued its dominance from frontline players to outscore Miami 42-16 in the paint and pulled down 46 rebounds to the Redhawks 35. Second-year coach Mike Woodson wasn't all that pleased with his team's early play in that matchup, but conceded they got better as the game went on. Meanwhile, Arkansas Little Rock had a battle with Jackson State last Sunday and came away with a 94-91 triumph over the Tigers. It was just the second win for the Trojans, who are now 2-3 on the year under fifth-year coach Darrell Walker, who has an inexperienced but pretty talented roster that has been solid offensively but needs improvement, according to their coach, at the defensive end of the floor. Well, Eric Suhr, Indiana continues to showcase a front line to date that hasn't been stopped and a deep bench that continues to complement the starters.
They really have, Don. Indiana, we talked about it before the season started, the Hoosiers have a deep team, and it's not just deep in the front court. All positions, 1-5, Indiana's got not only really skilled players, but they've got a bench that Coach Woodson can bring in and mismatch different lineups. And we have seen Indiana do that at times this year. Indiana's played really well, and they've got a couple games here coming up, and then next week a huge test against North Carolina. Hoosiers cannot afford to look past these next two games. Tonight's game against Little Rock is going to be an important game for Indiana to continue playing well, push that momentum forward so that you're playing your best basketball for the Big Ten ACC Challenge when North Carolina comes down over here to Bloomington to try to take on the Hoosiers. It's a big contest for Indiana, but you can't look past these next two ball games.
No, that's always what could happen in this early in the season, and it could happen with a basketball team if they're not mature enough to understand that and have gone through the wars, so to speak, having played in games like this before. You're expected to win this game, and you're expected to win it handily. So if you let down your guard a little bit, things can happen pretty quickly.
They really can. These kids, Don, it's tough being a college basketball player at times. These kids for the last couple of weeks have been told how good they are, not only by their classmates, but by their family. You know, they're starting to feel the hype a little bit. And I think a challenge for a younger team, a team like Indiana that's got a lot of hype, is just to keep a level head, to continue to try to do the things that you've done to get some success. I'm not worried about this team, but it's just so common you see teams come out flat in games like tonight when you're supposed to win big and you've got a big game coming up. To come out flat, I think, is a very, you know, easy thing to do. So far this year, Indiana has had some success and has come out and looked pretty good almost every single game that they've played. I expect Coach Woodson to get this team ready for tonight's game against a Little Rock team that has really struggled in some areas, but has some ability and they've got some players. So Indiana's going to have to play a good game tonight. And the challenge for the Hoosiers will be to come out early and put their foot on the gas and put Little Rock away early in this game so that they come away feeling really good about themselves and have some momentum and some confidence going into next week.
Little Rock is kind of what we expect from a ball club in the Sun Belt. They don't have tremendous size. They've got a couple of 6'8 guys that are big, physical-looking players, but they just don't have that 7-footer, the 6'10 guy inside that's a banger. But Myron Gardner, a 6'6 senior at 220 pounds, is leading this Arkansas Little Rock team, despite the 2'6'8 guys they have on the front line. He is leading them in rebounds with 10 a game. That means this kid really goes after the ball.
Yeah, averaging a double-double. So for Indiana, blocking out is going to be really important. You've got to be a team that dominates the boards. When Indiana's successful, Don, they are rebounding at both ends. And we've talked at length about how good Indiana's been off of defensive rebounds. I'd like to see Indiana crash the offensive boards a little bit better. At times, possessions have gone by and you only have one, maybe two guys crashing the boards. I think tonight's a night you could take advantage of your size and your athleticism and get multiple offensive players crashing the boards. I think it's going to be important against an undersized Little Rock team, but you're right. Gardner's a guy that's averaging a double-double. To average 10 rebounds a game shows a lot of heart a lot of motor and some athleticism to go up and get those rebounds. So Indiana's going to have to be locked in, rebounding the basketball tonight against Gardner and the entire Little Rock basketball team.
And the other thing about Little Rock, they did score 91 points in their last, or 94 points in their last outing, and what had to be a track meet with Jackson State.
Yeah, so the pace is going to be huge tonight. Little Rock is going to try to push the basketball. They have some success when they can turn you over and then push the ball in transition. Teams are averaging over 17 turnovers a game so far to this point in the season. So they like to play hectic defense. Junk defense, are going to try to trap you. It's not a great defensive team. If you could take care of the basketball against this Little Rock defense, you could score a ton of points. But they're going to try to play at a frantic, frenzied pace. And for Indiana, the key is going to be taking care of the basketball, running your half-court sets, playing great defense, and then picking and choosing when you push the ball in transition. If Indiana can take care of the ball tonight, I don't think this Little Rock defense has the size or athleticism to get stop after stop against this Indiana offense. But taking care of the ball is going to be really important tonight for this Indiana offense.
We will bring you the play-by-play story about 1 hour from now. Our pregame show is presented by IU Credit Union, an official partner of IU Athletics. We started a credit union and created a community. When we come back, John Herrick will join us for the Governor's Cup update. This is Indiana University Basketball on the CareSource Radio Network from Learfield.
That to-do list you have needs one more thing. Chill. It's an easy thing to do. Just crack open an ice-cold Coors Light and chill. Take the afternoon off and binge-watch anything. Go to happy hour and stay for a couple hours. Who's counting anyways? Or hang out with just your dog because you've had enough human interaction this week. Whatever you do, do it with a Coors Light. Mountain Cold Refreshment made to chill. 2020 Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Celebrate responsibly.
Don't take a chance when buying a used car. Drive Honda certified from your local Honda dealer, where we have 1 to 10-year-old Hondas. Protected, certified, warrantied, and backed by Honda. Certified pre-owned Hondas have a 182-point inspection, have been reconditioned with Honda genuine parts by factory-trained technicians. Plus, you get up to a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty, roadside assistance, and much more. Only at your local Honda dealer.
Why is Culver such a treat for so many families? Here's a hint. This treat is thick and creamy, and everyone can get it any way they like. Our fresh, frozen custard. We craft it in small batches throughout the day to make our guests stay. Shakes, cones, sundaes, concrete mixers, flavor of the day. Oh, and the toppings.
Who says you can't please everyone? There's more than one way to dessert at Culver's. Welcome to Delicious.
Culver's is a proud partner of IU Athletics.
Get back in the game. As the official healthcare and sports medicine provider of IU Athletics, IU Health Southern Indiana physicians, orthopedics, and sports medicine specialists are dedicated to caring for injured athletes, from the college superstar to the weekend warrior. We can tackle any injury and get you back in the game and back to the activities you love. Get expert care close to home. Call 812-333-BONE or visit iuhealth.org/bloomingtonortho.
Indiana is filled with wonderful people and places. So whether you live in Anderson or Attica and need an injury attorney, Green & Schultz Trial Lawyers will be there. Bloomington or Brazil, Gas City to Goshen, Huntington or Hammond, Green & Schultz makes it easy to help you. Jasper, Jonesville, Lebanon or Linton, Mitchell, Muncie, Plymouth and Portland, Seymour, Tell City or Union City, Warsaw, Washington, or even West Lafayette.
Green & Schultz Trial Lawyers, attorneys serving victims of injury and loss. More at greenschultz.com.
Hoosier fans, depend on Master Rental for all your rental equipment needs. Whether you're a contractor in need of an excavator or a homeowner doing a weekend deck project, Master Rental is the only place you need. They're your go-to resource for all your home and garden maintenance needs. With the largest, most current rental fleet in the area, including Bobcat, Echo, Exmark, Honda, and Simplicity, Master Rental is your full-service rental provider. Let us take care of you like we take care of Hoosier Village.
Hey,
It's time for the Governor's Cup update. I'm John Herrick. Indiana leads Purdue in the Governor's Cup race, 2.5 points to 1.5. The next chance for Governor's Cup points is this Saturday when IU takes on Purdue in the Old Oaken Bucket game. Indiana's won 5 of the last 8 contests with Purdue there, including a double overtime win on the road in 2019. IU will be looking to join a select group in the history of the program to win both the Old Brass Spittoon and the Oaken Bucket in the same season. Now, there are no Governor's Cup points available for the men's soccer team because Purdue does not have a men's soccer program, but the IU men's soccer team is currently worth mentioning, though, because they advanced to the 3rd round of the NCAA tournament for the 8th straight year by beating St. Louis 1-0 last Sunday. I spoke to their coach Todd Yeagley about that win this week.
Well, yeah, felt great. It was a cagey game. A lot of these games are tight. St. Louis is defends really well and made it really difficult, you know, for us to get a lot of opportunities. But you know, Ryan Wittenbrink's been fantastic for us this year and scoring big goals, and that was a big one. So we didn't have a couple really good looks, but the decisive goal was a beautiful one, and we're just excited to get to advance and get another home game, which we're really excited about.
Yeah, and that home game's coming up against Marshall. What do you look for out of them? What do they bring as an opponent?
Well, they're very talented. This is a team that, you know, we lost to in overtime in the championship game just 2 years ago. You know, they've come a long way. Marshall's certainly a program that's been good, but really in the last 3-4 years have really come out, and they're heavy international. They're experienced. They're older. There's 4 to 5 players that, you know, played in that championship game on their team, similar to our team. And, you know, this is going to be one heck of a match. And we just really excited for this opportunity, obviously, for us to get this home game. They beat, you know, the top seed in our bracket, Virginia. And so obviously they're capable of beating anyone. And we're going to have to play really well. But I like where we are with this group. And certainly at home with, we just hope the students and the fans from Bloomington come out on Sunday night to help us.
What would you say the overall keys to victory are?
Well, our defending is going to have to be spot on. They're a very dynamic team going forward, which I think we always take a lot of pride in our team defending, individual defending. So if we can solve the matchups, I like our chances creating the ones that we need. And we're going to, you know, certainly try to be smart when and where we press them. They're very good. And I think, obviously, when we look at any postseason or tournament run, restarts are the difference. And, you know, that might be the difference again on Sunday.
All right. He is men's soccer coach at IU, Todd Yeagley. Todd, thank you so much for the time. Good luck to you on Sunday against Marshall.
Thanks so much.
Elsewhere in IU athletics, the IU volleyball team has 2 matches this week against Illinois and Maryland tonight and Friday, respectively. They're coming off an upset over 5th-ranked Ohio State this past Sunday. The now 6th-ranked IU women's basketball team takes on Auburn this Friday night in Las Vegas at 8:45. Then they face Memphis Saturday night at 8:45. Up next is our Hoosier Profile interview with Jalen Hood-Schifino. This is Indiana University Basketball on the CareSource Radio Network from Learfield.
Let's be frank. Your home, vehicles, business, and life are a lot like sports. The unexpected can happen at any time. Insurance may be the last thing on your mind, and that's okay. It's the first thing on ours every day. You can depend on the DeHays Group and Frankenmuth Insurance to be on your team. Visit the DeHays Group today at DeHays.com. That's DeHays.com.
Looking for someone to cater your next corporate event, family reunion, or tailgate? To some, a garnish may be nothing more than just a decoration put last on a plate. But in Bloomington, catering starts with Garnish Catering. Serving all of Bloomington and surrounding areas, Garnish Catering is waiting to help make your next event one to remember. Planning a great event shouldn't have to be stressful. Whether we quote you just for catering or a total event package, you can trust that you're making the right choice with Garnish Catering. Visit GarnishCatering.com. That's GarnishCatering.com. Garnish Catering is a proud partner of the WOW Network.
Before you grab a shovel, use your laptop or smartphone to contact Indiana 811. Remember, buried gas and power lines are everywhere, and if damaged, can be extremely dangerous. To keep you and your family safe, make sure you contact Indiana 811 at least 2 days before you dig. Just go to indiana811.org and submit a locate request. Then wait for your utilities to be marked. It's a free service. Safe digging saves lives. So click before you dig at indiana811.org.
Proud partner of Indiana University Athletics.
Upland Brewing Company is proud to be the official craft beer sponsor of IU Athletics. Upland has been brewing award-winning craft beers right here in Bloomington for 25 years. Whether you're looking to explore striking new flavors or sit back with a pint of Dragonfly, Indiana's best-selling IPA, Upland beers are the perfect pairing for your next tailgate. Join us at any of our six locations or find us at a grocery store near you. As always, Upland reminds you to drink responsibly and go Hoosiers.
Taft, today's modern law firm. With more than 675 attorneys across 11 offices, we provide solutions to the business issues facing middle market and emerging companies alike. We do this through a highly collaborative and inclusive team approach. Taft, the modern law firm and a proud sponsor of IU Athletics. To learn more, visit taftlaw.com. TAFTLAW.com.
Whether it's 12 miles to the Pee Wee football comeback of a lifetime, 80 miles to your first hole-in-one, or more like 8 shots to the first hole, whether it's 240 back road miles to sleeping under the stars, or just a few blocks to the grocery store, Marathon has the fuel to keep your engine running at peak performance. Because you never know where life is going to take you. For quality fuel through every mile, fill up at Marathon.
Back here at Simon Scott Assembly Hall, Indiana, getting ready to take on Little Rock tonight at 6:30. Now it's time for our Hoosier Profile interview. Here's Don Fisher.
Our guest in Hoosier Profile is a freshman on this Indiana basketball team, Jalen Hood-Schifino. Jalen, first of all, tell us a little bit about your background in basketball. I know you grew up in Pittsburgh, your hometown. Tell us a little bit about your background and how you got involved in basketball and a little bit about how you were able to grow through it.
Yeah, like you said, I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Grew up in a basketball and football family, so I would say pretty much as soon as I was born, I was kind of, you know, into the game. So in the backyard of my grandparents' house, we had a basketball court, so I remember just always being out there with my uncles and my granddad and my older cousins always trying to, you know, shoot the ball and get it to hit the rim, and I couldn't get it. So I remember finally, you know, getting the ball to hit the rim, and from there on out, I just, you know, was always outside working on my game. And fast forward, when I was in sixth grade, me and my mom and my sister moved to Charlotte, North Carolina, and then I think that's really when my life changed as far as, you know, basketball wise, because, you know, Charlotte, North Carolina, well, just North Carolina in general, it's like a, they call it like the hoop state. And I was able to meet some people down there and play on a, you know, organization, the Team Charlotte, which is ran by, you know, Jeff McGinnis, a former NBA player. And I think that really helped me and helped my stock as far as like on the national scene. So people were able to see me and I got national recognition. And, you know, just throughout my high school career, you know, I had like a top 25 ranking, you know, held in my head. And then my junior year, I went to Montverde Academy, you know, national powerhouse, you know, won 2 national championships. And then, you know, now I'm here at IU, so it's been a long journey.
And a pretty good one at this point.
Pretty good one, for sure.
Tell us a little bit about your decision to come to Indiana. What struck you about Indiana University?
Indiana started recruiting me, you know, right when I got to Montverde, actually. Like, I think, like, that first month I got there, I got a call from Coach Kenya Hunter and Archie Miller, who was the coach at the time. You know, I really liked, you know, the coaching staff, especially Coach Kenya Hunter. You know, always, you know, had Indiana in the back of my mind. But to be honest, I honestly, at first, I really wasn't, you know, considering Indiana, to be honest. And then once Coach Woodson got the job, he called me, and then, you know, the coaching staff started to change a little bit as far as, like, you know, who he brought in, and I started to really build more relationships with everyone. I think that's really when I was like, wow, I think I can really see myself going here. And then PGM of the EYBL, my junior year, they were at every game, full staff deep. So I was like, wow, that's like the only school who did that for me. So I think they really prioritized me and I really felt wanted. And, you know, and they were honest, you know, with me throughout the process. You know, they told me the things I wanted to hear and the things I didn't want to hear. So, you know, for me, those are big things for me. And, you know, Coach Woodson's an NBA guy, and that's obviously where I want to get. So I think he can help me, you know, get there.
Without question, and you've had a good start to your season. You've been starting every ball game at this point as a freshman. That's saying something at Indiana. But at the same time, you've performed well. You seem to have a very calm kind of presence about you on the floor with your teammates.
Yeah, that's honestly just the way I act off the court. I'm pretty calm and relaxed, so I think it translates on the court. I think just my poise at the age. You know, I haven't really been shooting the ball that well, but it hasn't hurt us any, so it's been fine. But now I'll be better, and you know, it's still early, so I'm still growing. Like you said, I'm just a freshman, so I'm learning on the fly and just working every day. So
you having fun with your teammates?
Of course, for sure.
You're getting some leadership from the older guys too, I'm sure.
Yeah, exactly. Like you said, I'm the only freshman out there, and the rest of the guys are, you know, older guys, seniors. So, you know, our older guys have been great, you know, been teaching me, you know, helping me out, and, you know, just being there to encourage me.
How do you like the campus so far?
It's been pretty good. Got some food spots that I like to eat at and everything, so it's been pretty cool.
It's a little colder here than Florida, man.
It's definitely colder. I think around this time in Florida, we're able to wear shorts outside, so it's definitely a little different. But I'm kind of used to it being from Pittsburgh, so it's kind of like I'm being back there a little bit.
Well, I really appreciate you taking the time. We'll look forward to talking to you again as the year goes on, and continued success.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Jalen and Don. When we come back, Smithville presents the Big Ten and Top 25 Basketball Report. This is Indiana University Basketball on the CareSource Radio Network from Learfield.
Smithville has been the proud official sponsor of IU Athletics since 2009. Let's hear from head coach of IU football, Tom Allen.
I just think that it's a great thing that Smithville has been a supporter of Indiana Athletics since 2009. That allows us to have a tremendous amount of trust in them, a lot of confidence in them, for us to be able to know that they're always going to be there for us.
To learn more about Smithville's first-class internet services, call 800-742-4084 or visit smithville.com.
Libman makes a difference. The Libman Mop Crew is part of our winning team. The Libman Mop Crew makes sure the hardwood is clean and safe for the players every game at Simon Scott Assembly Hall. No matter what kind of flooring you have on your home court, Libman has the tools to keep it clean. Our mops, brooms, and brushes are proudly family-made in the USA. Visit Libman.com to see our whole lineup and for a store locator. That's Libman.com. Libman, official sponsor of Indiana University Basketball.
Where you work and who you work beside matters. We are Daymar, and we're dedicated to helping vulnerable kids and adults with disabilities. Right now, we're looking for tough people with big hearts. People who are fighters. People who don't give up. People who run toward danger to do whatever they can to help. Is your job fulfilling emotionally, or are you just filling time? Learn more about open positions at daymar.org.
IU Credit Union.
Hey, Hoosier fans! IU Credit Union has a great lineup of IU Athletics MasterCard debit cards. Choose yours from a roster of six iconic IU designs and show everyone you're a Hoosier. Check them out at IUCU.org or visit any IU Credit Union branch. IU Credit Union is an official partner of IU Athletics.
We started a credit union and created a community.
Whether you're cheering on the Hoosiers at Memorial Stadium or simply want to experience the vibrant energy of IU Bloomington any time of year, there's no better place to stay than the Biddle Hotel inside the Indiana Memorial Union. Located in the heart of IU's campus, the Biddle Hotel provides first-rate amenities within this quintessential college town. For reservations, visit imu.indiana.edu. That's imu.indiana.edu. The Biddle Hotel, where all Hoosier fans belong.
Hoosier fans, the IU basketball season is here, and so is an exclusive offer on Cooper Tires from Neal Tire and Auto Service. You just became an instant winner. Provide the code IUCOOP30 at any Neal Tire store to receive $30 off any set of four Cooper Tires, plus a free alignment check. Again, the code is IUCOOP30. That's IUCOOP30. This offer will expire January 31st, 2023. So stop by Neal Tire to take advantage of this special offer. And remember, Hoosier fans, nothing beats a Neal deal.
Now it's time for the Big Ten and Top 25 Basketball Report, brought to you by Smithville. Smithville's your local choice for internet, voice, TV, and security. Stick with the home team. Visit smithville.com for more information. Smithville is an official sponsor of IU Athletics. Games that have gone final so far today in the Big Ten: Wisconsin edges Dayton 43-42 in the Bad Boy Mowers battle for Atlantis. Ohio State upsets 21st-ranked Texas Tech 80-73 in the Maui Jim Maui Invitational. Coming up tonight in a battle of 5-0 teams, Northwestern takes on 13th-ranked Auburn in the Cancun Challenge. Tip-off at 8:30. Also tipping off at 8:30, 4-1 Michigan is facing Jackson State, who is 0-3. Jackson State is Indiana's next opponent Friday afternoon. And UNLV is taking on Minnesota in the SoCal Challenge. UNLV is 5-0, and Minnesota is 4-1. Top 25 games going on right now. 7th-ranked Baylor all over McNeese State, 73-47, less than 7 minutes to go in the second half there. 15th-ranked Kentucky on their way to a victory over North Florida. They lead 96-51 with a minute 25 to go in the second half. 14th-ranked Arizona leads 10th-ranked Creighton in the Maui Jim Maui Invitational, 39-30. 3rd-ranked Kansas beat NC State earlier today, 80-74. While we have a moment, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Indiana University basketball. Up next, Don Fisher returns with Mike Woodson and the head coach's report, brought to you by the IU Credit Union.
Broadcasting from the Shepherd Community Center Studio, this is Indy's Mobile News, 93 WIPC, WIPC HD1, Indianapolis.
Need of an excavator or a homeowner doing a weekend deck project, Master Rental is the only place you need. They're your go-to resource for all your home and garden maintenance needs. With the largest, most current rental fleet in the area, including Bobcat, Echo, Exmark, Honda, and Simplicity, Master Rental is your full-service rental provider. Let us take care of you like we take care of Hoosier Village.
With the Kroger Plus Card, it's easy to get lower than low prices for the win. And for every dollar you spend, you earn fuel points, which can add up to $1 per gallon off at the pump for the win. Plus, save every day on groceries and get personalized digital coupons for the win. The Kroger Plus Card. All you do is win. Big, big savings. Sign up now at Kroger.com and start saving. Kroger, fresh for everyone. Savings may vary by state. Fuel restrictions apply.
It's the Ford Shine Bright sales event, and Ford is helping you be a light for others this holiday season. Right now, get special offers on select Ford trucks and SUVs. Come in and choose a vehicle in stock, or simply place a custom order, lock in your rate, and you're protected. Hurry in to your local Ford dealer today and find the Ford vehicle that helps you shine bright all season long. Not all models, trims, or features may be available or may be subject to change.
Now available throughout the Bloomington area are fresh home-cooked nutritious meals all prepped for you. The Fresh Fork takes the hassle out of planning, shopping, and prepping. That's right, it's the fastest, simplest, and easiest way to avoid decision fatigue. Simply pick a weekly or monthly plan, select the meals you want, and pick them up at BB's Market once a week. So leave the heavy lifting to us and enjoy healthy eating with stocked meals in your fridge. Order online today at thefreshfork.com. That's thefreshfork.com. The Fresh Fork is a proud partner of the WOW Network.
What they want is the silver lining, and they want a promise kept. When something really bad happens, that's when, you know, you absolutely present a West Bend versus maybe another carrier.
An independent insurance agent describes the silver lining.
What I'd want you to know about West Bend is that you have a partner, and you have a partner that cares, that's built on strong values, and in the event that something does happen, you have a promise that will be kept.
West Bend, the worst brings out our best. Visit thesilverlining.com to find out more.
People come to Goldcasters even from Indianapolis to buy their engagement ring, their anniversary gift, their important purchases with us. They figured out they'll have to visit 5 major jewelers in Indy to find all the brands I carry here under one roof. This is my passion. I scrutinize and handpick every single diamond we carry.